Changed my life.
Okay. Well, it's actually to do with the band. To do with our band tour.
Right. Because you were saying this is going to be life-changing for me personally.
Yeah. We all know we're going on tour at the end of November, yep. Start of December. Yep. With our band, you're driving our tour bus from Melbourne, mm-hmm. snake our way up through the eastern states, finish in Byron Bay on that Friday. Mm-hmm. We have a big gig. That will be life-changing for all of us. We'll have a fantastic time. It's the first time we've toured as a band. It's a big step in any band's career. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're going to learn the song and all that sort of jazz. We're only playing one song and taking it on tour. But the gigs are locked in. Everything's going great.
Have you been practicing?
No way, man. You're not a nerd. Yeah. I know you have.
No, man. I would never.
You have.
I
didn't want to bring this up on the show, but you were messaging last night about, you know, the trumpet and stuff. I'm like, Jack, he's sitting at home practicing like a bloody baby.
Mate, I would never. You're
terrified of the gigs, and that's why you're practicing, and it disappoints me. No. I'm way too cool to practice.
No way, man.
And I won't be for at least another 2 weeks. Yep. Not till I'm scared of the gigs, and I'm not scared of the gigs, and I think you're scared of the gigs. That's why you practiced.
Didn't practice, I'm not scared.
The problem is, your second job on the tour, is trumpet, which is not 100% necessary, and if you don't make it to stage... We'll be fine. Well, it's fun. It's a bit of fun.
Hey.
It's a bit of fun.
Guess what?
Yep.
Does this ring a bell? Do, 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 do.
We've got Jack. He can do it perfectly. It's fine, Ando.
Jack has said his voice doesn't go low enough.
We welcome you on stage. You're welcome anytime, but you are like the parsley. Wouldn't kill us if we took it off and ate the meal without it. But your first job is as a bus driver.
No, I'm a bus driver second. I'm a musician first.
Well, certainly to me and Jack, we're like, we couldn't do the tour without you being a bus driver.
Yes.
And it's such a huge role for you to take. Driving the bus from Melbourne to Byron.
Got my heavy, rigid vehicle license.
You went and got your bus driving license. We're so proud of you. Mm. Obviously, we'll give you a uniform as the day gets closer.
I'll get my own uniform.
Like shorts and long socks and all that sort of stuff. There's just one thing missing that Jack and I were thinking about. And the more we think about this, the more we both agree it's a must, don't we, Jacko?
Yep.
Like,
feels like you're just going along with this ride over there.
I think you'll do it because you're a team player.
It, I think, would mean a lot to the band and to Australia as a whole if you took. Do you take your bus driving seriously? Do you?
I do.
And do you? Okay. And do you take good causes seriously?
Depends on the cause.
Oh, I would say. I mean, mental health.
Yep.
Good. I think it would be the right thing for you to do to grow a moustache to be the bus driver. And not only grow a bus driving moustache, because we're touring at the end of November, which is Movember.
Yep.
You grow a Movember moustache, a moustache, and you dye it silver. Because that's what bus drivers look like. You have a silver moustache.
I look exactly like my dad.
Yeah, like, you look like your dad's dyed his hair black.
Yeah. No, but like, you know, if I'm wearing a hat and I go home, Mum might try it on.
She might jump you. I'm not saying there won't be added benefits to this. There won't be a silver moustache lining. Now,
I mean,
I know.
No, I mean,
I knew you might. I talked to the Movember guys.
Yep.
You can start tomorrow.
You know I need a rush on.
You need a runner. I talked to Brett, who's one of the one of the founders of Movember.
I'll do it.
He's given you a special dispensation.
No, I'll go November. You're doubting my mustache growing ability. My mustache is fine. My beards are terrible.
All right. Well,
I think you'll be happy with my mustache. It's just my beard that requires fire breaks.
He has given you this is a huge gift though from the organizers of Movember.
Yep.
They've said, yeah. He can start as of today if he wants. If you want to run up.
Because
I want full bush.
I don't
want
to be one of those wispy guys that tries to cheat and lead in. Nah.
That's exactly who you are.
No, I know, but I'm not.
But I want a full bush by November 28th so we can dye it silver.
Hey, 28 days, I'll be fine.
Congratulations. May I donate $10 to the mustache?
You're a bastard.
It'll help cushion because you've got to, what's that instrument, the silly
I can't play with
you
it.
Play?
Oh, no.
Yeah. We are in a band, Cool Boys and the Frontman. End of November, we have our tour. We're obviously going in the bus from Melbourne, snaking our way up.
Playing year 10 formal.
Yep.
Pub reopening after it's been closed for a year in a very tiny town.
Playing a lot of great gigs all the way up the east.
University graduation ball after that, Newcastle.
Yep, for nurses that you picked because it's full of girls. So as we snake our way up to Byron Bay, for our last show of the year, we will be playing at the Beach Hotel in the afternoon, always with a new front person, and things are going great. Things are tracking well. I obviously, being in charge of Buzz, I'm always looking for ways to get the name out there, get the band out there. I've got Jared, the social media guy, running the Instagram account, and he's providing a wonderful behind-the-scenes peek for fans of the band. But
what are we up to on Instagram?
22,000.
Really?
Followers, yeah. People love the band, man.
Heck, wow.
People love access.
Yes.
And that's the thing that Jared's able to provide. And I give him full free reign. He's put some stuff in me up there that I'm not happy about, boys, but...
Well, it seems pretty positive towards you on the most part.
I just say to him, mate, you write whatever you want. You write whatever you want to write, Jazz.
Never met Jared.
No, you won't, because he's a professional and he doesn't want to get it in your face.
If you give someone access, normally they take it.
Hey, he's got it. He's just sneaking around. More of a sniper. Ninja sniper. So today when I had a mate email me a snippet from the Melbourne Triple M Breakfast Show with Mick Malloy, Luke Darcy, Eddie Maguire. Terrific show. They're an allied show of this show, good friend of the show. And I thought, oh, here we go. Somehow, they're talking about Cool Boys and the Frontman. I thought we had a bit of band publicity. Have a little listen to this is Mick Malloy chatting.
Story about Andy Lee playing in a band, and I had no idea, but Andy Lee plays the trumpet.
Yeah.
Right, so he's reading out of the paper, and I thought, oh, great, there's a story about Cool Boys and the Frontman in the paper. Isn't this terrific? Andy's in the paper talking about Cool Boys and the Frontman, our band.
Yeah. I know what this is.
Then, unfortunately, it becomes clear that unsatisfied with what we give you as a band, you're moonlighting for your brother's band.
Yes, which is a good band.
Yeah. Is it?
Yes.
Pick.
Pick? Really?
Pick two. What I'm saying is, it obviously deals a huge blow to Jack and I, because you're in the paper with your trumpet. I've seen the photo now. You're holding your trumpet like they caught you, and you just like always have your trumpet. And I'm sitting here going, Andy's trying to. I see what he's doing, because we always have a go at you for it being a novelty instrument. You're trying to get it out there like it's a serious tooting instrument.
It is a tooting
instrument. Well, Mick continues, right? Okay. Listen to this.
I didn't know that either until today. Actually, I did read that.
Pretty soft, isn't it? Right. Hamish play a bit of jazz flute, does he? That'd be...
All right. See what's happened? Because of your choice of novelty instrument. Now, I, a bloody rock and roll drummer, I'm being labelled as a jazz flute player by Mick Malloy.
It'd actually be harder. I'd be more impressed.
Oh, well, Mick wouldn't. So, Mick, now it's just stacks on because you've made us a beacon for teasing, and then listen to the end.
Kind of. Doing the trumpet. What's he doing? Sit at home with his Louis Armstrong cheeks, belting out a couple of numbers.
Hey, mate.
At what point did he pick up the trumpet? What kind of private schoolboy upbringing is that all about?
I read that that's been a passion of his for a long time.
And that's Luke Darcy at the end going, I've read that it's been a passion of his for a long time. And where did he read that, Jack? In the same article we read?
Yep.
The article where, Ando, you're quoted as saying, I was studying music and I wanted to be a musician.
Yep.
Mate, blow it out your ass. Don't blow it out your trumpet. Blow it out your ass, mate. This double life you're pretending you lead, where somehow radio got in the way of you being David Helfcott on the trumpet. You did a few classes at school, okay? You played in your school orchestra. You weren't studying music. You got a loose knowledge of what some of the notes mean. You know about keys. You know about B flat. You weren't studying music and you weren't going to be a musician, mate. I was a bloody ray of sunshine and a golden lifeline. I saved you from a life of untalented tooting, and we've done it again and given you a leg up, and now suddenly we're being made to look in the paper. We're a joke. We're not even mentioned in your article.
You didn't even mention
the band, and you made it look like we've stopped you from going to the Conservatorium of Music. It's a rift. I can't put it any other way.
Okay.
We're in an official rift period, and it might last several hours.
Okay. Don't watch the Channel 7 news tonight.
You are unbelievable, mate. Yeah, just...
Play on. Song, Jack, please.
No. Minute silence. To punish you and the listeners for what you've done.
Hey, we do have a tour. We've got a band. Yep. You're on electronic drums, Jack on electric guitar, myself on trumpet. Our band is called Cool Boys and the Frontman. We've booked in a tour where on the 28th of November we'll jump in our bus and we're playing people's parties, people's events.
Yeah, it's going
to
be awesome.
As we head to Byron Bay. We're a tour of one song. That's one of the rules of our band. We only play one song per gig.
Yeah, that's all we really need. People get the gist after that.
Chosen Uptown Funk.
Yep.
And then it came up last week where we thought maybe, you know, if people are going off and we need an encore up our sleeve, we work on a secret song.
Yep.
And now, I regret ever bringing up the secret song and us working on it because it has been a cause of issue in the group.
Well, the thing is, we don't know who the front person will be for each gig. We've got a rotating guest singer to sing Uptown Funk. And I guess there was a mood in the band of, wouldn't it be fun if during, you know, the rehearsal time or having a jam, we could have another fun song to play? Because it's hard rehearsing Uptown Funk without the singer.
It's just hard rehearsing it because it's hard.
Yeah, but is there any other fun songs we can think of to play in? Yeah, the idea for this secret song came out. It's certainly a musical challenge, but there's no missing bits. It's just trumpet and guitar and me on drums.
So we caught up for a jam session today, and look, secret song came up.
Yep, because we did play it on Friday. We learnt the secret song on Friday. It was going to be a secret. We were going to never mention the secret song. We have to admit that there is a secret song floating around because in the end, the secret song is the source of a bit of a rift in the band.
All right. 5 weeks till we're on.
Do you want to...
I feel like you guys are keeping something from me.
No, not at all. I mean, you've just highlighted there's some spots that you want us to work on and...
All of the bits.
You want us to practice more, you said.
Well, yeah.
Okay. Do you want to practice Uptown Funk or the secret track?
I want to put a blanket ban on the secret track.
Are you joking?
I'm not joking. Until we get Uptown Funk right.
That's, to me, that's the big problem because I only like playing the secret track.
I've noticed because Uptown Funk's too hard for you.
It's too hard. It's like, well, I mean, this is, it's easy for me, but it just doesn't feel like we're nailing the song, does it? Be honest, Jack.
It's way more fun to play the secret song that we play.
Yes, because the secret song's easier.
Would it be crazy to tour the secret song?
Just so what, drop Uptown Funk?
I don't know. We love playing the secret song. I love playing it. I downloaded it on Spotify, put it on my playlist on the weekend, made a playlist called Songs I Can Drum.
And it changes the name of our entire band.
Yeah, I know. It's just an instrumental song.
And there's no vocals in the secret song. So we would no longer be Cool Boys and the Frontman. We're just
Cool Boys. We can still be Cool Boys and the Frontman.
No, we're not, because we don't have a frontman.
No, it's actually easier because you don't need a singer.
Exactly, so you don't have a frontman, so it's just Cool Boys.
No, you still have a frontman to introduce the band.
What do you mean?
So we can have anyone you want out there. You can have Richard Wilkins for one gig, just dances.
But he's not a frontman.
Well, he's the frontman of the band that night.
The frontman is the lead singer, the lead performer. That's what a frontman is.
That's what you've interpreted it to.
Well, that's what the world has interpreted it as.
I'm just saying, are we sheep that just follow the rules of the world, or are we wolves who make up our own rules? What I'm saying is, all those who think playing the secret song is heaps of fun, say I.
And you do.
You must admit, you love the secret song.
I like the secret song a lot. But I feel like you are only liking it because it sounds good.
We nailed it in 15 minutes.
If we don't vibe for this song, we should change the song. We booked a tour based on this song. People have booked us based on this song. We booked another bass player that we're not meant to mention.
Yeah.
Who is like...
Is he learning it?
Well, he's rearranged a lot of gigs.
Has he?
And he's taken the week off to come with us.
Which I appreciate.
He could still play in the secret song, could he?
There's no bass in the secret song.
That's true. It's piano.
Can he play piano?
Well, yeah, he can, but...
Can we just do the secret song once to get in a good mood?
We're so good at it. And it hardly took us any time.
I felt like we were a gifted band.
Okay, secret song.
Yes. Here we go.
Censored. Secret song recording. Censored. Secret song recording.
How'd that feel?
It feels good. It feels fun, doesn't it?
It feels really good.
I'm going to work on a couple of bits, but...
See how, like, you just really get into it. I'm buzzing.
Yeah.
Quick, before it wears off.
Okay.
Secret song again. So look, we should also point out, at this stage, obviously we're keeping the secret song a secret.
Well, it's meant to be an encore secret song. That's the whole point. People are meant to go, oh my God, they actually know another one.
Yeah, and and that's going to be fun.
We've got to go to a song here.
I just want people to know that, in case you see anything going, oh no, so is Uptown Funk not being played? Mm. Yes, at the moment, it still very much is being played. Mm. We had another crack at it after that. It was fine.
I think I've got something I want to propose to you guys that might settle this mess.
It's not a mess. We're having a small vibe crisis brought on by a good thing, which is we enjoy playing another song heaps. And I'm sure bands face this. Like the Beatles probably loved playing Sgt. Pepper, and then some of their other stuff, they're like, oh God, do you have to play that? But they had to, because that's the deal.
After this, everybody, I'll put it to you too. Because there's something else that came up that I've got a little bit of a snippet of.
Okay.
And I've put a solution to you.
Band in crisis.
Here's what came up also in our jam session, everybody.
Just seems like we're in a trough, a motivational trough with Uptown Funk. Sometimes in troughs, you know, that's the time to hop off the bus. At the bottom of a hill. Because everyone knows how slow it takes a bus to climb up the hill. And do we jump to another song? Doesn't have to be the secret song. Long Way to the Top was mentioned, AC/DC.
Yeah, do you know how hard that is? if Jack's finding this Uptown Funk hard, where he literally dabbles a little bit on the guitar, and then...
Getting Nando.
Get in trouble.
No, you're not getting in trouble. Do you see how stupid that is? You're picking the hardest guitar song in the world.
That's true. Should you play it now, and if you can do it?
If I can impress Andy. I mean, I...
Don't do that. You won't be able to do it.
Here's what I'm proposing. If you guys get hot and cold on things so quickly...
We always knew this would be a risk.
We need a level of commitment from you two to something.
I understand. This is exactly what I was scared of.
Okay, so what about this?
Being held to something.
So what about this? How about you guys have 1 week... to learn Long Way to the Top.
Oh, okay. Skill-based challenge. So I don't have to decide now.
So next Monday, we all jam again. We come in.
Mm-hmm.
We put Uptown Funk on ice, which it has been since the very first rehearsal, and you couldn't get through it, and you've sulked, and you don't want to do it.
I actually got the furthest through it, even with two injuries, tennis elbow and my old bloody shin splints from my paper round injury.
So next Monday, we get together.
Just change the record there, Trump. So stop trying to manipulate everything. Let the record show. Trumpet. I don't want to sound like Hillary.
Trumpet.
Yep. Donald Trumpet over here. You can Google it. You can Google it and fact check it. I won't insult everyone's intelligence by fact checking everything Andy says.
So anyway, that's been on ice. Fair to say, it hasn't really been practice since then. You guys, individually or together, practice Long Way to the Top, and then come Monday.
I know.
We have a run through, and if we like that and we think it's in a better position to Uptown Funk, we can do a change.
If not, we continue with Uptown Funk, which even you now saying we're not doing Uptown Funk anymore, I miss it a bit. So it's the power of grass is greener, isn't it?
So anyway, 1 week?
1 week and we finally decide. The tour's still on. The repertoire
is changing.
Is a movable feast.
Yes.
Secret song is locked in though.
Year 10 formal, I think they would have preferred Uptown Funk. The reopening of a pub in a small town in the middle of New South Wales. Probably Long Way to the Top.
Suppose you'd have to check with your venues to go, are you still cool for us? You did book a funk band. We now might be playing AC/DC. In the meantime, we've had a complete band change. Or if we get our way, just the secret song. good. Great food for thought. Well done, Ando.
We're in the middle of a band rift.
We're having a little band rift, aren't we? For people that have been listening to the show regularly over the last couple of weeks, they'd would have followed the journey of us reforming our band, who have played 2 gigs in the past and deciding to go on tour. Tour starts November 28th. So here we are exactly pretty much 4 weeks away from touring.
Four weeks away from leaving. 4 weeks away from the first show.
First gig. And it's
playing at the Wodonga Catholic Girls' School for Year 10 formally.
And if those... No, it's not girls' school, mate. Stop trying to make everything girls' school. It's Wodonga Catholic College.
Oh, right. Well, there you go. Well, Year 10, mate.
So well, I mean, you booked us you booked us at a nurse's graduation dinner where 90% are girls.
University,
just
a little bit more appropriate.
You knew what you were doing when you booked the nurse's gig. Here, what I'm saying is, a couple of weeks ago we had a song that we were starting to rehearse, and it's fair to say that a few members of the band weren't feeling it.
Two of you.
I'll feel anything, man. I'm the drummer. If it's got a beat, I'll find it. The problem is,
eventually.
Jack, we were trying to play Uptown Funk, trying to rehearse it for, you know, everyone knows. That's what we were going for.
This isn't us.
This is again, can't stress this enough. That's Bruno Mars. Awesome.
Yeah.
Great song.
Yeah.
That's what we're going for. It wasn't feeling like that in the rehearsals.
No.
And from there, we had a bit of a vibe crisis, a well-documented vibe crisis.
You guys called a meeting. In that meeting,
yep.
Explained the vibe crisis,
yep.
And then I
wondered aloud. All we were doing was wondering aloud if we should pivot songs.
Yes, and pivoting left was Long Way to the Top, which is what...
Well, that was a huge popular one on Facebook. People saying, you know, here we go, play this.
Yeah. We don't have a bagpipe right now.
Well, we've got a trumpeter. You might have noticed. He's always trying to pipe up.
And then when this was suggested in our jam session,
when we were thinking out loud,
I got a little bit surprised that this was suddenly after we'd been meant to have been practicing this for a number of weeks.
You weren't keen on the pivot from Uptown Funk to Long Way to the Top. This is what happened in rehearsals.
Long Way to the Top was mentioned, AC/DC.
Yeah, do you know how hard that is? if Jack's finding this Uptown Funk hard, where he literally dabbles a little bit on the guitar, and then...
I didn't know we'd get in trouble.
No, you're not getting in trouble. Do you see how stupid that is? You're picking the hardest guitar song in the world.
That's true. Should you play it now, and if you can do it?
If I can impress Andy... I mean,
don't do that. You won't be able to do it.
But we agreed at that point that Jack had 1 week to come back and play Long Way to the Top with the U-Ham on drums. We'll jam it out on Monday.
And that's next Monday. How are you feeling, Jacko?
Yeah, get some practice done over the weekend for sure.
Yeah.
I will.
It's because
I feel like I've come up and you guys, you know, have been jamming a little bit.
I've been trying to, you know, all I got to do is lay down a basic beat for Jack, because it all comes down to you, Jack. I mean, that song is a guitar song, no doubt. Here's the thing, though. We're in this cheeky rift at the moment.
Yes.
We're not practicing together. We're not really talking about the song. And rifts happen in bands, guys. What we have to decide is if this is the rift that will break us or the rift that will make us stronger. Okay. Talking to Tim that works here with us, he's in a band. He's just gone through a rift as well. They had a bass player come into the band, and the bass player had studied music. Okay. He was the only one of them that had studied music. Tell me if this sounds familiar, Jacko. And was always telling everyone in the band what to do with their instruments, going, oh, you might want to do this a bit here.
Practice them.
Yeah, because he'd studied it, so he's going, I'll play a B sharp there, you know, lose that C minus or whatever. Whatever he was doing, music chat. And they just went, who's this guy think he is? It's five guys in the band. And they're just like, this guy's just giving us all this technical feedback. And it created a rift in the band. Their bass player is now very much on the outs. Yeah. They've got to decide, do we cut this guy or do we tell him to just tone it down? I mean, you could take a leaf out of that book, Ando, of just toning it down a bit. You're not the best at all the instruments. You play a novelty instrument. You're even drumming along to the Target ad that was playing in the Target in the ad break before.
Yes.
Looking at me like, this is how you play drums, mate. Like, I could play the Target ad. Don't worry about it, champ.
It was just in time, which I suppose was the exciting thing.
Well, easy to be in time with air drums. What I'm saying is, 13-10-60, we're in a rift.
Yeah.
I hope we get out of it.
Mm.
For the sake of the tour, I hope we get out of it. But if you were in a band, have you been in a rift before?
Are you currently in a rift?
Like us? Did it blow the band apart?
Yep.
Or did it make you guys stronger? Did you come up with a solution?
And what were the tools to get through it?
Band rifts, 13-10-60.
Joel, you were in a band, went through a rift. What was the band name called, Joel?
It was Iconic Justice.
Are you from Iconic Justice?
How old were you when you were in Iconic Justice, Joel?
About
16. Yep. Yeah, and that usually when you are 16, you are the icon of justice. Yeah. What was the riff, Joel?
Well, basically, our lead singer thought he was Bono. So, I mean, the drummer and he did not get along eye to eye. Yep. Thought he was above everyone, talked down to everybody. Bit similar to you, Andy. maybe just cool it a little. Maybe change the instruments. I don't know.
Great advice, Joel. Call anytime. I'm going to give you a secret number so you can go straight to it.
Hey, Joel, how did you solve it? How did you solve it? Did the
We didn't, mate. The band broke up.
Band broke up.
Iconic injustice. Joel, look, I suppose how could a year? So, what are we talking? Year 10, year 11? Are you playing covers or originals?
He had many originals that he wanted us to play that were pretty rubbish.
Yeah.
So we played maybe two covers
at
the school once, and then that was about it for us.
Okay. Yeah.
That's a bad rift.
Well,
I feel like we're a better chance of getting through our rift than Iconic Justice.
Yeah, exactly. And I feel like the frontman guy was more of a jerk than I am.
Yeah, definitely.
Not to say I'm not a jerk, but...
No. It was just a good zing from Joel, and I loved it.
Nick.
Hello.
How are you, mate? You in a band rift?
I was back in the day.
What was your band name, Nick?
We were the G Strings.
Nice.
Yep.
Yeah.
Sweet, man. And what was the rift over?
Well, we needed a drummer.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, Hayden wasn't available at the time.
Yeah. Appreciate it, Nico. I would have been on that, like, sauce on a hot dog. dribbling off the ends.
we ended up putting up a piece of paper on the community notice board with all the little bits hanging off the bottom.
Yeah, the tags and the off. Yeah, the number. Details. Yep.
Yeah. And the drummer took one and he rang us up and we said come over, and so he came over, brought his whole kit in the garage, and he asked us what we could play, and we said, we can play the first verse of Blink-182, Damn It. That was about it. And he got the poos with us and ended up leaving after about 30 minutes. And that was it.
This guy sounds a bit low like me.
Yeah.
30, essentially, the band only existed for 30 minutes.
Yeah, about that.
Hey, Nick, did you consider learning more than one verse of one of the easiest songs ever to perform before putting a call out to all drummers? That would have been so annoying. He's going to take his whole kit, the most cumbersome thing, set it all up. Should we do the first verse again?
He wasn't local either. He was about 45 minutes away.
You want to stick around and have some beers with us? No, you're going to go to you. Okay, see you, mate.
Thank you, Nick.
Bad luck. These things could have been huge.
So these are things we're going to...
That's why hopefully on Monday, Jack, you are able to...
the most cumbersome thing. Set it all up. Should we do the first verse again?
He wasn't local either. He was about 45 minutes away.
You want to stick around and have some beers with us? No, you're going to go to you. Okay, see you, mate.
Thank you, Nick. Bad luck.
These things could have been huge.
So these are things we're going to avoid here.
So you can see how quickly a rift becomes a permanent break. That's why hopefully on Monday, Jack, you are able to show us, me and Andy, the rest of the band, that you've got the showmanship and the guitar quality needed to pull off a long way to the top.
So are we going to play along with Jack on Monday, or are we just going to sit back
and
watch
him? I can give him a basic beat, but don't expect any flair happening from the drums. That's just for show night.
And I'd like just to sit...
You sit back and judge.
Yeah, like...
Get you an X Factor chair.
Simon Cowell or something, and I'll sit back and judge. That'd be great.
I mean, Jack, you called the pivot.
Well, I remember the challenge being you and I had to learn the song. Now, all of a sudden, you're in the pivot chair, and there's absolutely no pressure on you, but I'll learn it.
Looking at a bit of a free weekend for Blakey.
As if you're going to learn it anyway.
Saturday's looking clear.
Excited to get to this bit.
It's time.
Haim, you and Jack and I, we're in a band together. It's Cool Boys and the Frontman is the name of the band. There's two rules in our band. Whenever we gig, we only ever play one song.
Correct.
And we find a new frontman.
All woman
for every time we gig, front person.
Correct. We go on tour in less than 4 weeks. Mm. You've got your bus driver's license. We bus off. We've got our gigs booked.
We don't have a song.
We don't have our song locked in.
And this
we did.
This is the cause of a riff last week. You and Jack had obviously had a bit of back channeling, and you guys had discussed that you'd lost your vibe for Uptown
Funk. It's not back channeling. If you're in a band, I would say it's quite normal for the members of the band to talk about how things are going in the band.
Yes.
I mean, Bono and The Edge wouldn't be at the footy and not mention you two once. Like, I think Bono might go, hey, you know we're doing the fireworks, the streets have no name. Yep. Do you reckon that's working? Well, and the Edge might go, he might say, Bono, relax, man.
Yeah.
We're just at the footy. We'll talk about band stuff later. But he also might be allowed to talk about band stuff. And that's what happened.
And you two are the Adam and the Larry of our band. You're not Bono and the Edge, just so you know.
Look who thinks he's Bono, Jack.
And
he
thinks he's Bono and the Edge.
Well, that's crazy. Because surely I'd be Bono and the Edge because I get two votes in the band.
Okay, anyway. We discussed this being a quick intro.
Okay,
to
we're gonna get to this quickly.
Anyway, so what? We gave Jack a week. He had suggested Long Way to the Top.
Yeah.
He had a seconder from you, Ham. But we said, we give Jack a week. This is such a guitar-heavy song.
It is.
That you have to prove to us that you could pull it off.
Because Uptown Funk wasn't sounding like it sounds on the radio. That was our main problem.
This is true. So Jack came together. We had a jam today.
Mm-hmm.
This is how it started off.
Well, here we are.
You'd be nervous.
Me?
Did you practice?
Yeah, I did. I practiced.
Wow. Show off. What a nerd.
I knew he'd practice.
I knew he'd practice. I knew you'd practice. So annoying.
Today is the day where we have a good, solid look at Long Way to the Top by AC/DC. Angus Young, probably one of the greatest guitarists of all time. Yeah. Better than Mozart.
Yeah.
Better electric guitarist than Mozart.
Absolutely.
See?
Yep.
You think you're as good as Angus Young? Think you're better than Mozart?
Well, I've had a weekend of practice. And
no, see, that, the thing is you need the arrogance. You need the...
Yeah, that's
I
said to Haim on the way in today, Jack, I just said to Haim, he can rock up and play all the notes fine today, but I'd love to see some swagger. Right. You know, like,
why? Because what I... That's
about flair as well, isn't it?
It is. I mean, that's the whole point of this song. It's. I mean, I could play the notes. But then who's going to drum? So yeah.
Can I be honest then? Yeah. I prepared for this audition to do the notes.
You prepared, prepared the notes, not the flair.
Not the flair.
You didn't have to learn the whole song.
Sure, I can do flair for another week.
You don't have to learn all the flair. Just to see a bit of it.
Just play us a bit of the... I think the thing is, there's the guitar solo in the song.
Can I just start by jumping that bar first? If you think...
Let's just hear the start.
What do you want? Do you want me to lay down the basic beat?
Well, I had one other thing I was going to ask.
Okay.
Can I play it to a backing track on YouTube? Because he doesn't know the song yet.
That's fun.
I just don't want to be like judge in the middle of notes if you're doing one of those faces that's like, where are we supposed to be here?
No, do that face a bit. Okay. I would get you back there because I'm just worried he's going to, if we play off the YouTube one, he's going to hide behind Angus. I mean, anyone, it's like, can I see?
Are you overriding? Yeah. Suck it, Jack. Andy's putting me back on drums.
Well, but you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
You know, anyone can sing with a backing track.
Word of warning.
Yeah.
I've got a pretty sore foot. So I might have to pull out at any time.
Okay. Good luck, Jacko.
Is this too loud? Because I turn it up loud.
No, if we're going to do this, we also have to have like 10 times as many speakers.
When has Angus Young ever got?
Is this too loud? I mean, already. It's a worry. Exactly.
No, I'm not doing flair today.
Okay, sorry.
I'm not doing flair.
Yeah, will you on gig night? Or will we have to make an announcement to the audience? Unfortunately, tonight Jack Post's flair didn't show up. So you'll just be playing the notes, sitting down having a cup of tea. Please enjoy this rock and roll.
I'm learning bit by bit. Okay. I'm starting with the notes.
Yeah.
I'll do flair next week.
Well, it's a lot more roll than rock at the moment, my friend. Okay.
It's the opposite to me. I'd start with flair, and then I'll learn the notes right at the end if needs be.
All right, good luck.
That's way faster than it goes.
Okay.
Awesome.
Moments later.
It's good.
Really good, eh?
That sounds a lot more like the song than maybe we're at with Uptown Funk.
Yeah,
with all the instruments present.
Yeah, well, that's the thing, isn't it? It sounds fuller. Sounds coloured in a bit more, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It was a good start, was it? I mean, it's a slow start. We only played the first kind of 30 seconds.
Our first gig is 4 weeks from tonight.
Yes. Yep.
I just thought, since we came up with this fun idea of going on a band tour 10 weeks ago, 6 weeks ago, we had 10 weeks of the gigs, but 6 weeks ago, we're still trialing what song might be fun to play. Don't get me wrong, I think this is a very important process.
Jack was sounding good, I thought.
He was sounding good,
but then we questioned, hang on, that's the easy part.
People
that
know that song.
What about the solo that Angus plays? And we put that to the test after this. Everyone stick around.
And can I just say, throughout this whole thing, people would know that there's a bagpipe solo in that song. Yeah. And we assume you can play that on trumpet. That's a big assumption to make. And I think one thing that's gone by without the due credit is that this is a super, super low flair song on drums.
Yeah, right.
Filming an enormous team player here by accepting this.
That's why it's sounding a little bit more.
No. Like, and that's,
I think that's probably why it's sounding more
you
in the
guys,
slot.
No,
more in the
no doubt love it because you're taking away the guy that's normally able to impress the crowd very effortlessly with his drumming.
Yeah.
And you're silencing me. You're silencing a star player. Yeah. Will it work? Will it get us the premiership? I've got my worries.
Well, we had to test whether Jack could do the solo aspect, which you're right, does have the bagpipes normally alongside it. So
yeah, so you guys are having fun.
This is
like showing off, but there's no actual drum bit. But again, I don't mind. I'm there. I am a team player, but a little badge or something, like a little medal would be nice maybe for the drummer.
Anyway, we pick it up testing Jack on the solo part.
Can we get a little bit of your solo? The guitar solo is the hard part, and that's the part I didn't really want to play with the... The natural
with the band's drummer. Well, okay. Hey, yeah. Hey, actually, Andy, Hamish here from the drums. Yeah, there's a few bits of the song that I'd like Jack not to be in, and we could just get the YouTube backing track up for the bits where I don't think his flair's good enough.
Most of the song I don't want to play with either of you.
Hey, join the club, mate. So we're in this, and we've booked a tour. We haven't even solved the trumpet issue yet. Do you think you can do bagpipes on the trumpet?
Yeah.
You can barely do trumpet on the trumpet.
All right, let's play Me and Home. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do 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 do. Do do do. I can do a little bit better, but hey. I have gone away and practiced a little bit.
That shows practice. Nerd.
Yeah, you're nerd.
But
nerd.
Good for the song. But
Jack, that's really good stuff. Oh, thanks, man. That's the first compliment I've ever received in the band.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm looking forward to getting one now as well. How's the drumming?
And we waited and waited. And it never arrived.
There'd be no compliments that night.
Once the sun set and the moon was high, I took my sticks and went home, realising that the compliment would not be arriving that day. Maybe tomorrow.
Here's the thing, guys.
Okay.
You've heard both of them.
You've heard both of them. This is the part, this is a very important part in a band's life. Let's say, much like Coldplay, before they go on a tour, they have a lot of fights and they have a lot of arguments over the song. And this is the bit where they go, okay, we'll take it to the fans and they can decide our set list.
Yes.
Do we, once and for all, 13-10-60, we've got Uptown Funk, which we were getting some progress with, versus Long Way to the Top.
Do you want to hear a sample of both? This is us with Uptown Funk. Okay.
Not bad.
And this is
why does it sound like a school orchestra? That's probably, why does it sound like the Year 9
the guitar?
I would think the trumpet.
I feel the guitar.
Trumpet is such a high school orchestra instrument. No.
Jack does have a point. It's the guitar. I think it's because it's sort of like...
It's the guitar.
And
it's the tentative, the weird tentative guitar.
I think because the trumpet too, like it is a high school...
No, it's not.
It's one of those instruments where it's sort of like, hey, come on, guys. Let's give them a pat on the back. They're playing something groovy and contemporary.
Okay, and here's a Long Way to the Top. Obviously with a much better front man than
that
myself.
That was a holding vocal. Okay, 13-10-60, we have got to solve this. We've got so many more different arguments to have in the band over what song we're playing.
Yeah.
Far more personal attacks I can be throwing at you two over song choice. Yeah,
exactly, we'll find it after this.
They're both great songs, and we'll get them up to A-plus level. Don't worry about that.
Which one should we go with? Kobe, What do you reckon?
Boys, ahoy, by the way. I'm going to go with AC/DC. I just felt like there was so much more, like, passion in it.
Plus,
Cackle and Jack killed it. Like, just killed it.
Oh, he didn't have any of the flair or the showmanship, but he was playing the right notes.
Kind way of saying that he was terrible in the other one, Kobe, and I appreciate you going for the positive rather than the negative.
And possibly through the other one. We don't know, Kobe, because he was a bit resistant and reluctant to Uptown Funk. But having said that, if we do choose Uptown Funk, we'll force Jack to get better at it.
Okay, one more vote for a long way to the top. Andrew, you're going to the Rankin Springs gig.
Yeah, I am, boys. I certainly am.
Andrew, nice, that's huge. That's our second gig on the tour.
In the middle of New South Wales.
Smack bang in the middle of New South Wales. A town of 300. We're playing the pub reopening. Yeah. Andrew, are you from Rankin Springs? Are you from the surrounding area?
Yeah, I'm from about 15 k's out of town. So,
still in the CBD, basically, of Rankin Springs.
Andrew, which one do you want to go with then?
Oh, I think personally for me and everybody else that would be coming to the Springs event, I'd say the AC/DC.
Yeah, what a shock.
What a shock. Pretty big call to let us know that AC/DC is popular at a pub reopening in a country town. But this is the kind of thing that Coldplay, etc., don't get with their people going to their gigs. They don't get to have a little phone conference to work out the playlist, and that is something we should utilise.
Yes. John on 13 1060, which one are you thinking?
Well, it's a real hard call, isn't it, really? Like, I reckon that Uptown Funk, my kids dance to that. Yep. They do a bit of hip-hop dancing, and they do heaps better at it than what I could listen to that.
Yeah.
So I'd definitely say Long Way to the Top. Because that Uptown Funk was disgraceful.
Okay, John. That's the long run up at just saying an Uptown. Do you want to single someone out then in the Uptown Funk?
John, yeah. Can I just say,
we're not going with Uptown Funk now, so it seems like we're getting laughed at.
Decided on Long Way to the Top, which is a huge turning point for the band. But John,
if you want to single someone out, one last jab at the worst player in Uptown Funk.
Trumpet, that sort of shaky guitar.
It sounded like, I reckon it was Bozo the Clown that was the worst.
Who's that?
That's what it sounded like. It was terrible. Okay. I don't know who was bad, but the trumpet wasn't good.
No, John, we've had to change song. And that is official. Straight from the voice of the people. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're just tuning in, now hear this. Attention, we have an announcement to make from Cool Boys and the Frontman. This is official. Judah, issues we could not rectify with our novelty instrument, the trumpet. We have been forced to change 100% of our set list, and we will now be playing Long Way to the Top on our gig as we head from Melbourne, snaking our way up the country, playing gigs along the way.
Yep.
Basically the story of the song as we go of the
halfway
to the top of Australia. In our tour bus, we're so sorry about the trumpeter and what he did to Uptown Funk. Mark Ronson, Bruno Mars, if you're listening, please accept our apologies. We've ditched your song. We're now playing AC/DC. Are we all decided? Hands in?
Yeah, well, you guys are the ones that keep changing.
Well, you don't even know if you can play this. It's a bagpipe solo.
I'll be fine. It's not a problem.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
How's your day been?
Yeah, good. Thanks, bud.
If you just joined us, I'm about to shave Andy.
My face.
Yeah. It's complete hot towel shave service, though.
You said you went down to the salon below.
Yep.
And to fill everyone in, I am growing a mustache for our trip.
Bus trip. If you're going to drive our tour bus for our musical band tour, get a mustache.
Yeah.
We're going to dye it silver. Before we dye it silver, we have to grow the damn thing.
Yes.
Can't talk about what meal we're going to cook before we've grown the vegetables. Yep.
And I don't have the greatest beard or mustache growing ability.
Yep.
So I'd plan to let it just kind of grow out in a more of a beard form and then work it, whittle it back to a moustache. But you...
I thought it might be fun to give you one of those deluxe hot towel shaves you see advertised.
What kind of shave are you using?
I don't shave. Sorry. We were making conversation. I don't shave.
No, what kind of shaver are you using on this?
Shush now. So just covering up Andy's face here, putting a hot... That's a nice hot towel, isn't it?
Is that what they do?
I think so.
So Hamish is just putting a hot towel on my face.
don't think that was necessary, but...
This is sort of... So I think there's just a lot of hot towels involved, isn't there?
I don't know. I've never had one of these.
So I think they're just sort of holding face washes on your face. I think the idea is it just... I don't really know why they use a hot towel. Just heat up your face. Does that feel nice?
Well, it kind of does. I mean, at the moment, Hamish is cradling my...
Close your eyes.
My face with a hot towel. So that's nice.
How's that?
It's over the eyes. But again, aren't we meant to be getting a bit of a...
Why don't I do that and just keep your eyes covered?
No, I don't want my eyes covered because I want to see what you're doing. So what kind of... No.
It's one of these...
No, we're not using...
It's a straight blade razor.
It's, I know, it's a Sweeney Todd.
it's a Toddo.
Sweeney Todd. There's a film and there's a musical about the fact that that's the exact kind of blade he used to kill people. Is it sharp?
Yeah. Just shaving. Oh, look at that. Shaved patch of my arm. So I guess you do sort of just scrape.
Aims to scrape.
Sue, what I might do... Now is
but I think wouldn't they wet my face first?
Yes, of course. Here comes some wetness. I'm just going to put some shaving gel, foam it up. I've got one of those. Whoops. I've got one of the little brushes.
Jeez, you've just
yeah. Sorry, it's foaming. Foaming. Obviously, I don't need to do the moustache. I'll just do the beard where I'm going to shave. Mm. How's your day been?
I'm nervous.
Watch the cup, did you, mate?
I didn't watch the cup.
Yeah.
I had to hang out with a friend.
Oh, sounds fun. Mm. Get a bet on, did you?
I didn't. Oh, I did, actually, but we lost all three.
Oh, great.
Mm. No, not great.
Yeah, sorry, man, I'm not really listening.
So you put shaving cream on. I can't see what you're doing. And for a guy that doesn't ever shave, I'm worried that you're the man in charge of this.
No, I do know what I'm doing. I'll just wet my hand here. I'm probably... Probably need a few more towels. Look, here's what we're going to do. I'm just going to do the first shave on you here, sir.
So people can hear it. And
we've got a straight blade razor here. People can watch this on Facebook Live if they like.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what would your preference be, with the grain or against the grain? Your call.
I think go with the grain.
Do you?
Mm.
All right. God, sorry, my hands are a bit slippery because they've got shaving cream all over them.
Maybe she's got a blade to my face right now.
Here we go. How's that feeling?
It's growing a bit, isn't it?
Is it? Because it's growing a little, isn't it? God, your ear's in the way. Do you use both of your ears, mate?
Yeah, I do. Are you cutting?
Use your ears a lot?
Is it coming off?
Oh, how do you do this? I mean, yeah, it's... Something... Oh, bit of a cut there. So we're just going to go to a little song here and I'll keep watching on Facebook Live. Mate, do you mind if I switch to the other razor?
That'd be much better, I think.
Yeah. This is just too slippery in my...
And you've already cut me once.
I'm giving you a little love cut there, like a love kiss, but sharper. Yeah. All right, here's a cool track, and we're going to finish the old shape. What I've really got to think about is those mustache borders, mate. Here we go. How's your day been? Yeah, so I don't know about that Brad and Angelina thing. I reckon there's more than meets the eye there. Oh, anyway, we're back. Sorry. Hamish and Andy driving you home. If you've just tuned in, I'm just in the middle of giving Andy a nice hot deluxe shave. Like, you would pay good money for it at a barber's, but you get it for free, my friend, on the house.
Yeah, I can't believe how much of the slop. That's not shaving cream. It's a slop that you've procured. And the amount that's on my body.
Well, the good news is... Just finishing up now under the Shannon Knoll area.
Mm-hmm.
I've given you a moustache. Because you've got quite a cheekboned face and a sort of sweepy black hair, I've given you a slightly French moustache. I think you'll enjoy it, sir. Thanks for coming in. How's the rest of your day looking?
Thanks.
Yep, there you go. I'm just going to wipe your face clear here.
Yep.
Oh, gross. Look at that moustache.
How have we gone?
Pretty good.
Hamish is wiping that off now. I'll give him the book.
What's
the angle? I mean, I felt it didn't seem like the normal type of moustache.
It's just so funny seeing you with a moustache. But I got to say, you look like a World War One pilot.
Oh, yeah.
You love it. Look at you. You love it. You love it. You just fell in love. I've never seen you look at a girl like that.
Yeah. This one.
Oh, no.
It's only downhill from here. So which way have you got? Okay. I can run with that.
Yep. Facebook Live. I want to see those borders stay the same. I think we're finished at the Facebook Live here, but do go to hamishandy.com or check out the social pipes, and the mustache begins. Now grow, my beauty, grow, and we shall dye you nice and white.
It'll be at least double this length in 4 weeks.
$25
now. Oh, no way.
Haim, of course, in just 3.5 weeks, our band goes on tour. We're called Cool Boys and the Frontman, everybody. If you've just tuned in, welcome. We'll recap, and sorry for going over old ground for people that regularly listen, but yourself on electronic drums, Jack on electric guitar, myself on trumpet. We've got a band together. We are touring. We've got an amazing bus. We're going to head up the East Coast, stopping along the way at people's parties, their functions.
Because we're playing Long Way to the Top now by AC/DC as our only song.
We only ever play one song in our band.
And it was mentioned yesterday on the show, we are going Halfway to the Top. Mm. Is that the name of the tour?
Halfway to the Top tour.
Pretty cool.
Yeah. Well, maybe we bring that up tomorrow. Let's lock that down tomorrow because we've got something else we need to concentrate on.
Well, I mean, should I put the padlocks on it but not close them? Because it seems pretty close.
Okay. Yeah, sure.
I'll tie it down and we'll lock it if needed.
Okay. Yeah, sure. But Haim, the song is Long Way to the Top now. There was a song pivot.
Yep.
We started out with Uptown Funk. Long Way to the Top. We tested it with Jack. His guitar skills seem good enough, or at least they'll get there.
Yes.
There's a part of the song where bagpipes are played. That's where the trumpet was going to be subbed in. This is the... I mean, you guys can be the judge, but there's probably a few concerns, would you say?
Well, yes. Bagpipes are a wind instrument. Yeah. Trumpet is a wind instrument. Mm. That's probably where the similarities end. And you're going to hear the differences in a moment. So this is the first time that the trumpet's tried to be the bagpipe.
Yeah. All right.
Okay. Well, I'll just give you... I'm just playing basic beats.
Yeah. So do you want us to give you a couple of... Yeah. Chugs through it and then you join in.
Sounds good.
Why don't we start from It's a Long Way?
Yeah.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
Okay. Any time, Ando?
A little bit of the body of it once we go to the...
Is that the best trumpet you've got? Play it again. I know the bagpipe and the trumpet are a different instrument, but are you playing... Can you push harder or something?
Yeah, I feel like that's what's going to be my feedback. Like, do more into it.
Because the bagpipes in the song are just like, I am here, I'm a bagpipe.
Yeah, right.
And you're going, excuse me.
So maybe should I play it higher?
Play it higher and louder if you can.
The bagpipes really sound big.
It's because they're bagpipes. It's not a single trumpet.
Okay, mate, come on. God, when Trumpet is Cracked, Volume 3, out now, $19.95, available at all good music retailers.
Okay.
All right. Yeah, go a bit higher.
I'm getting that familiar feeling we often get in music where... They're like, uh-oh,
trumpet
problem. Anyway, all right, okay, all right. Give me the cowbell.
Yeah.
That sounds a bit like an angry elephant that we're after. What's that bit where at the end it goes,
that's me trying to put the bit of grout on it, but it's a tough work.
So it's hard to play stronger.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm just learning. I
literally just assume you blow in one end, you get that silly sound out the other. It's as good as you can hope for, but you sounded like you were playing a bit harder.
Yes.
Can we build your lungs up somehow? We've still got... Do you want to quit smoking for a month?
Do we... Change a song?
Oh, boy.
We're not changing the song.
Not.
And I've never smoked. I realise I didn't say it.
Nah, so, I reckon, in all honesty, though, Jack's away from his dog for a week.
Yeah.
I'm leaving my wife and child. I think the least you could do is give up the gaspers for a month.
Ham, our band goes on tour.
Real soon.
Well, yeah, 3 weeks pretty much.
Yeah, 3 weeks. 3 weeks, boys, and we're on the road and we're touring, and that's the most fun. That's why we invented this band tour, because we want to get on the road and we want to bring joy through music, which we're good at, to people Australia-wide. We got a lot of, it's a full week of touring. There will be very little rest.
It's our band, Cool Boys and the Frontman. You're on electronic drums.
Yep.
Jack's on electric guitar. I'm on trumpet.
Yep, doing your best.
And hey, we only ever play one song per gig, but people listed all the functions they had coming up towards the end of the year.
Yep.
And we're just going to weave our way from Melbourne, where the bus is, all the way up the East Coast.
That's
to it. Stopping at functions all the way along.
Hitting existing gigs. Now, thank you to everyone again who registered. Obviously, we can't get to all of them. We only are on the road for 1 week, and we need that rest day Thursday.
Yes.
So we are flat out ourselves. We're flat out at the moment trying to get the musical side of things up and running, because we know that if we're turning up to places like, for instance, the Tuesday night gig, Rankin Springs, middle of New South Wales, town of 300 people, but 1,000 people plus confirmed to be at the pub reopening in that town. We know when we turn up there, we want to put on a good show.
Yep.
And you can't do that without some level of band cohesion and showmanship.
Yep.
Except what we've found in the band
well, it's been 4 days since we've changed the song. The song is now Long Way to the Top.
We found in the band, and we found ourselves in a new territory. We're now in a situation where we were playing a funk song, Uptown Funk. We're now playing a rock and roll song, AC/DC. And a huge burden has fallen upon Jack. The electric guitar part of Long Way to the Top, many people would know, is the whole song.
Prominent.
Drums, I really take a back seat now. Some sort of small team player medal has been mentioned.
Yes, by you.
And it would be nice to see that placed around my neck or pinned onto my leather jacket lapel.
Interesting you're talking about awarding people with something.
Yeah, well,
we've actually got you a present, Jack.
Got you a little prezzo, Jack.
Because obviously...
Yes. Just in response to the last couple of days...
Hamish is passing over a blue parcel. Okay.
I thought you guys were happy with how I was going on guitar.
That's
for
why
the,
I got
we
you a
give you a present. Why would you
Am
give
I
some...
opening it now?
Yeah, go for it. Why would you give someone a present if you're unhappy with them?
What are these?
What is it?
They're boots.
Oh, yeah.
But they're way too small for me.
Oh, okay. Right. Would you saying that you are too big for those boots, are you?
Very good.
Okay. That was so satisfying. I feel like a caveman must have felt when a mammoth just wandered into the trap. Quite big for those boots.
So you're saying you're too big for those boots.
Well, that's interesting that you're saying you're too big for your boots, because that's exactly...
Not my boots, these boots.
Well, they're yours.
They're your boots now. And you're too big for them, aren't you?
That's certainly the feeling we've had as the other members of the band.
I'm glad you brought up the concept of too big for your boots, Jack, because we've put together a bit of... bit of a message we'd like you to play.
Yep. Okay. Obviously, you know, that's obviously you've just realised you're too big for your boots.
we've had an inkling.
We've had an inkling.
We've had a sniff.
In fact, we've catalogued how big you have been for your boots over the last 4 days.
It's been 4 days since we selected Long Way to the Top as the band's song, and we've watched Jack grow from a timid boy into an arrogant a-hole.
He's trashing studios.
Sorry, I knocked over a microphone.
Calling all the shots in rehearsals.
I'm still going to do no flair here. That's always going to be my feedback, like, do more into it.
I mean, you pulled out halfway through.
So it's hard to play stronger.
Yeah. He's scoffing at other members' approach to music.
He's got the music here for this one that we could potentially play in the band.
I use music, do you?
Well, yes.
Are you warming up or is this it? Have you got your sheet music up there?
He started using all this cool new language.
Guys, here's a rock and roll number.
And at times he's flat out refused to play with some other very talented members of the band.
Can I play to a backing track on YouTube? Because he doesn't know the song yet.
And treated others like a personal assistant.
I'll get a grilled flake and chips and a couple of calamari rings. Fried calamari rings.
So please accept your present, Jack, and treat it as a constant reminder. Pull your head in, shrink those feet, mate. Get back in your boots.
We all got up in fish and chips. We all got up in fish and chips.
Yeah, but that's a shame that you turned to me and ordered, yelled at me.
Sorry, Jack. I'm
trying
fried
calamari.
Just trying to do music. I think now's the time to specify how you want your calamari prepared, Your Highness.
Everything was taken out of context.
We do have our band tour coming up.
Pretty excited.
We are going to play our third gig ever.
Yes.
Which is exciting.
As the opening gig of our tour. But then every night of the week,
yeah,
except for Thursday, rest day.
We'll keep playing.
That whole week we're in the bus. You're the bus driver. Jack and I mucking around, playing PlayStation on the tour bus, maybe drinking at the bar. We'll try and keep it down because I know you want to make good time. But Jack, we're pumped for this tour.
Yeah,
Jack sleeping underneath the bus.
Yep.
As
keg
in,
monkey.
In his role as keg monkey, yep. Because our tour bus does have a bar, but those kegs aren't going to change themselves, monkey.
Yeah.
And just lucky that you and I got on the bus early when we did the tour.
And we're able to one of the two queen size beds.
There's two queen size bunks. Yes. I buzzed one, you buzzed one, and just because we're in a buzzing mood, we're able to buzz Jack the role of keg monkey. He'll be the guy that changes the kegs.
You're on electronic drums. I'm on trumpet and Jack's on electric guitar. We are playing Long Way to the Top.
Cool song.
And there's bagpipe solo in there.
Yep.
And which, you know, I was trying to substitute that out for trumpet. This is the part we're talking about. So we had our first crack at that on Wednesday.
It's so, I mean, because I've been listening to the song a lot, because that's how I crack a song on the drums.
Yeah, you just listen. Don't practice, just listen.
Don't practice, just listen to it 200 times and get it in your blood.
Yeah.
It's just such a great song. Like, I think it's actually illegal to be Australian and not like this song.
It was a popular one for them.
Oh, they did well out of it, didn't they?
Hey.
Well, not well enough, still touring, trying to make ends meet.
After we had a crack at that on Wednesday.
Yep.
This was the immediate feedback from the band.
Is that the best trumpet you've got? Play it again. I know the bagpipe and the trumpet are a different instrument, but are you playing, can you push harder or something?
Yeah, I feel like that's what was going to be my feedback, like do more into it.
Because the bagpipes in the song are just like, I'm here, I'm a bagpipe.
Yeah, right.
And you're going... Excuse me.
So maybe should I play it higher?
Play it higher and louder if you can.
The bagpipes really sound big.
Well, it's because they're bagpipes. It's not a single trumpet.
Okay, mate, come on. got tense.
It did.
Had to open a door after that.
Yeah, exactly. I went for a walk.
Take a little walk.
Yeah.
Which is fine because we were looking for a reason to stop rehearsing anyway.
So, you know, after that feedback that the trumpet wasn't bagpipesy enough.
But it was your first go. I mean, part of being in this band is quick and critical feedback.
131060, I want to ask this question. How hard is it to play the bagpipes?
Great, because we have had a lot of people on Twitter saying you should play them. Yeah. Someone sent us an ad. Yeah. They're only $190.
Okay, well, yeah.
Someone sent us an ad last night on Twitter going...
Band expense?
Well, no, that would be personal, unfortunately. But I didn't want to say this. I didn't want to bring this up because
we've got a lot. We
got a lot on our plates, and I don't know how quick you can learn them.
Well, that's what I'm asking. 131060.
But
are you a piper?
The notion was, how bad? I mean, does Andy care about this band or not? Was the feeling? Because I mean, it's fun. We know you played trumpet in year 10 and got a gold star for it. But how long are you going to rest on those laurels?
Yeah.
I mean, I've had to learn a brand new instrument. Coming into this band. I had was percussion skill. I had never been trained on the drums, and now look at me. You can do it.
I learned piano for the last song,
Never Tear Us Apart.
Couple of keys. You had to put your fingers somewhere anyway.
And went and got my bus license.
It was more you just rested your hands on a keyboard. I mean, well done.
Got lucky.
You rested them in the right spot, but it's not playing an instrument.
Got lucky. 131060, Are You a Piper?
Yeah, could you learn that song? Because wouldn't be more than a dozen notes.
I don't think it is more than a dozen notes.
It's just like recorder, isn't it?
That's what I think. So how hard is it to pipe? Give us a buzz. Andrew on 131060. Mate, you a bagpiper?
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy. Ahoy, Andrew. Do you pipe?
Mate, I'm a 50-year-old guy. I've been learning them since I was 13, and I still wouldn't say I'm competent.
So you've been... Are you a slow learner, though?
I've only got three fingers on one hand. You know, that's another story.
Oh, right. Okay. Is that true, Andrew?
No.
Okay, it could be true. Andrew,
have you 37 years and you wouldn't be confident to play that solo?
Mate, it's all got to do with the breathing. If you don't get your breathing right...
That's true, Andy. You will have to quit
smoking. You're in trouble. And I think the only way you'll get that amount of air going through the pipes is if you harness Hamish to them.
Yeah. Exactly, mate. Nice, big, clean lungs.
Okay. Well, that's a clean living, but... If you can pick any song, can I ask, why didn't you think something like Midnight Oil?
Andrew, we're not going back to picking a song.
Come on,
Andrew, we're touring in 3 weeks.
Andrew, thank you, Andrew.
It's all about lungs, Andrew. Keep them nice and clean. Yeah. Now, what's the first step to that?
I've never smoked in my life.
Maybe we chuck out the old crackers just for a month. That's all I'm asking.
Joe on 131060. You know, my mum asked me about that. And I said, Mum... I've had one drag in my life for a cigarette.
Don't.
And coughed everywhere.
Don't just try and smoke a pipe now and go, oh, bagpipes. It's good pipe practice. No. I want you off all forms of smoking.
Okay, Joe of 13.
Ahoy, Joe. Ahoy,
Joe. Sorry, I'm just dealing with a branding issue I've got. Because someone's. You work at Jordan, that's all right, yes, because someone is spreading rumours. Joe,
I'm just saying,
are you a piper?
I don't know what you do all the time.
I'm not, but I reckon you can still do it. Our school chaplain actually learnt the bagpipes for You're the Voice to play for our Year 12s at the Valedictory just a couple of weeks ago, and he did it in a month.
Awesome, Joe. What a chaplain too, what a legend. Isn't it crazy that probably two of the greatest songs ever made, Australian songs, You're the Voice and Long Way to the Top, both contain bagpipe solos, yet then there's a giant middle ground of average songs, none of which contain bagpipes. Then right at the tail end, there's some horrible songs with bagpipes in them. So it's a winner-take-all instrument.
So a month. Hey, Joe, just quickly, did you ask the chaplain how many days a week was he piping, like blowing in the
thing? I couldn't tell you off the top of my head, but he was working full-time during there, and he's got three kids, so it kind of been a full-time gig.
But he did have God on his side.
That's true.
So he had an advantage.
Exactly.
May the Lord look kindly upon your antics and help you.
We can put a good word in, I reckon. Michael, you're a piper.
I am a piper.
Okay, Michael, first of all.
So I've got one in the yes, it can be done. Andrew has been learning for 37 years and still can't play it, which I suggest means he should give up the pipes.
Yeah, it might not be for him. Mike, can you play that solo? I assume everyone would have a go at that.
Mate. That solo is probably the only solo I can actually conquer out of, like, any other piper song that I know, to be honest.
So it's a doable solo.
With 100% ease, but maybe not 100% with the breathing. You probably have to get me in the back with, like, a little breathing tube just to help you out a little bit.
Hang on, can you
certainly have to throw away those...
Can you pipe in another...
friends of yours, little white soldiers.
Can you get someone else to fill the bag?
I think he's joking.
Mate, what I'll do is, like, I'm really great with my hands. I can get, like, a tube and, like, put it into the back of your bag and run it backstage and I'll just be blowing on it for you.
I think he's joking.
I'm not joking.
Mike, is that possible?
Mate... Anything's possible. That's
it. Could we give Andy like a Ghostbusters? Yeah. We put a pump on his back and it pumps. Yeah. It pumps up. We make a backpack that pumps up the bagpipes.
Reverse
so he doesn't. So he doesn't have to inflate them.
Yeah, you can use my vacuum. I've got a Dyson.
No, mate, that's so generous of you, mate. We made a chicken
suit.
Not only is he offered
coming on tour with us, sitting out the back and just blowing each day, He's off his vacuum. So that's exciting.
So the toughest part will be inflating, and if we can take care of that, then it's just a matter of controlling the air out.
Should we get in a... Let's get a piper in tomorrow just to run me through it.
You know, you're not allowed to practice in city limits. There's some rule, or you have to go in a soundproof room. I think people drive out to the country to practice bagpiping.
It's not a rule.
It's a rule. It's a state rule.
Not a state government.
I can tell you're excited because now you don't have to worry about inflating the bag anymore, which means you can, you know, don't have to give up your favourite pastime. I don't know what you do. I don't see you all day.
3 weeks. We are going to be on tour with our band, Cool Boys and the Frontman.
Controversially, within the last week, we changed our song, which is 100% of our set list because we're touring one song from Melbourne, driving the tour bus all the way up to Byron Bay.
Very rare that a band will go on tour and have a completely, completely fresh set list
100%.
Three weeks before the tour.
You don't get it.
No.
I mean, it doesn't happen to Robbie Williams. It wouldn't happen to the big bands. They wouldn't say 3 weeks out.
Yeah. Let's change all that songs.
And I've changed genre.
Yeah.
Three weeks.
I'm going from funk.
You wouldn't have Coldplay going, we're rap, like we're a hip hop band now.
And even and more rare would probably be them going, I'm going to change instruments.
And that's what brings us to today. And for weeks, the thorn in the side of the band has been to accommodate your novelty instrument.
It was fine in Uptown Funk, and you guys just got bored of the song. It was actually perfect.
You were struggling. Mouth speed was a huge issue for you.
No.
Lung capacity and mouth
on
speed.
On the first one, but by the last rehearsal, it was fine.
Your tongue speed was way off. You were saying, oh, what if I kiss 50 girls a weekend? And we went, look, even if you doubled your amount of kissing per weekend to 50 girls, there's still no way you could get your tongue speed ready.
Anyway, long way to the top is the new song. And the new song has bagpipes in it, which was deemed not... when I played that on the trumpet, it was deemed not hearty, not... ...in playing for 37 years.
He said he can't do this
song.
He still
can't do this song.
But then
which worried us, but then... A couple other people said, no, you should be right. So we got a fellow called RJ. He's been playing the bagpipes for a while.
Yep.
Got him to come in with his pipes. And, Haim, you and I met up with him to discuss.
Could you just... We thought if you can just learn the first five notes of that solo, that will mean you've got a shot at learning this in 3 weeks.
Caught up with him earlier today.
RJ. Nice to meet you guys.
Hey, thanks very much for coming in.
Thank you.
Do I have to bring in your...
some Scots in your voice.
Some Canadian?
Yep.
Right.
Some Scots and Commonwealth.
Yep.
Yep.
Okay. Obviously, we're going to have an hour bash at this thing today. What do you think are the key things that I should be thinking about? Is breathing the most important thing?
I think you need to hydrate.
Hydrate? We're not running, are we?
Yeah. No. It's kind of like running. You feel like you've been running afterwards.
So it's a workout.
It's a bit of a workout.
I know it's a Scottish tradition to name your bagpipes. Do your pipes have a name?
No. Not yet.
No, I made that up.
Okay.
I was hoping this could be like, you know, Betty or something.
One question for you, RJ, is Hamish said to me, if I don't have a note out of it, like an audible note.
No, you need five notes. You need...
Within an
that
hour.
That first bit.
We've got to reconsider this whole thing. Do you reckon that's possible within the hour?
Well, I've set you up with like a learner bagpipe.
Awesome.
that's takes less air.
Yep,
and it'll be somewhat easier to get a note out of for sure. You'll get a note out.
So are the professional ones have bigger bags?
I brought
they?
Both. You can try both today.
Okay.
So are you like if, a big like bagpipe is louder?
Yeah, and if you want to see Andy really struggle, I've got the big boy pipes.
No,
I would like that, please.
No.
And then I've got
yes, please,
the little kitty ones as well.
Kitty ones, mate. They're just more of a travel one.
That's right, yeah.
Because kids like to travel.
It's more efficient.
You have to have an adult
with
you. It's
a fun size. Yeah, given the fun size bagpipes, the air problem is our problem, isn't it? Yeah. Trying to get the air going, because Andy doesn't mind a...
I don't smoke. I've never smoked in my life, and he's been, for some reason, pressing this rumor. I don't know why you're laughing. He's been pushing this rumor about.
So for someone that's obviously treated their lungs with the contempt that a cheeky smoker has, it would be easier for him to inflate a smaller pipe because of the damage done to his trachea, his areolae.
I have never...
airways.
I've never... ever smoked. I'm a swimmer and a trumper. I'll be fine on the big bag. Thank you.
Okay. But it means one whole month
with where Mr. Stuyvesant has to leave the room.
It's super helpful bringing Hamill on to the chat with the Piper.
Glad I was there.
I had a bash set for about an hour, Ham.
You did.
And then you guys were waiting in our rehearsal room with the
great
group band.
The great thing was we could see you in the news booth, which is soundproof, obviously, because it's a radio station. Yeah. So we could see you working hard in there with RJ. Yeah. We couldn't wait for you to come into the jam room. Make or break. I said, if you can do the first five notes of the solo, you can keep trying to learn this song. Mm. Otherwise, cut our losses. Mm. And it's obviously too hard an instrument to learn. Well, it's been exactly 1 hour.
Yep.
You've been in the news booth,
yeah.
So we've been able to see you.
A rehearsal space. Let's just call it a rehearsal space.
It's the news booth. Luckily, no pressing news issues have come up in the last little while. Well, here's the thing. You have to get the bit that goes...
We're on our way to that.
That was the deal.
We're on our way to it, is what I'm saying.
Well, I don't know, Jack. I just thought we had a deal. I thought you were going to come back in here when you could... Are you started yet? Or?
No, you have to fill them up.
Well, when will you be doing that on stage? Well, just sorry, guys. Everyone, close your ears for a second. We've got quite a noisy preparation. Can you fill them up and cork them?
You have to fill them up, and I'll get better.
Well, this is going to be happening on stage.
Yeah, but it'll be quiet because there'll be a lot of rock going on from yourself and Jack.
All right. Well, how many bars into it do you want?
Let me just get it filled up.
Great, because I don't know what a bar is.
Where will you fill up on the night? On stage?
What are you this moaning's going to come in the middle of our song?
There was no rules about no moaning beforehand. All I had to do was play the notes.
Well, when are you coming in?
I'll come in at the time he's meant to come in.
Do you want us to count you in? Have you done anything yet? I can't hear anything. Oh, there they are. I thought you were doing it for a while.
I got in there for a little bit, didn't I?
We heard. I thought you were doing it for about a half a minute before you did it.
I thought you started.
I thought you were doing it.
And
I was like, oh, mate, we've got to get him off the kids' pipes because we can't hear him.
All right, I'll see if I can play it for you.
Jesus.
Is this filling up?
Pretty good.
It's
there.
Pretty good.
That's all. I mean, it's we only asked for five notes.
Yeah, I mean, as I said,
it keeps carrying on for a long time.
It's like a whingy child. It keeps carrying on for a bit.
It's almost like the pipes know how well you did because they sort of end and go, oh. They do give you immediate feedback, don't they?
They do.
Oh, that's it.
So I suppose the answer is.
Destroy the trumpet.
Persist with pipes?
Let's run that trumpet over.
No.
Would be a nice gesture.
Well, I went and bought a new one for this whole gig.
You did.
It heaps of money on one.
Good.
Band expense? Was that a band expense, though?
Look, I did need to buy a new cymbal for the drum, so yeah. That's a band expense?
Oh, well, if you're... I think my trumpet was more expensive than your cymbal, so if you're...
I can spend.
Okay.
That's right. We'll have a talk about what's a band expense next week when we talk about merch. All right, boys. We've been talking about it for a long time. No more mucking around. In 3 weeks' time, we're on the tour bus.
Mm.
We're going on what has all the makings of one of the most epic trips of our lives.
Yes.
A real live band tour.
Yep.
We've had our ups, we've had our downs, we've changed songs, we've changed instruments, we've taken requests for gigs, we've locked them in, we're getting close.
We don't have a single frontman locked in.
We do not have a single frontman at the moment. We're an instrumental band, but If you build it, they will come.
Yes.
And we're barreling forth with great faith in our band tour as Cool Boys and the Frontman head all halfway up this country in our Halfway to the Top tour. Couple of things we don't have, and I blame myself for this because it falls under the category of buzz.
Yep. A drummer? A good drummer?
Buzz. This is just sort of the fun banter we enjoy as a group of guys that know will absolutely get the job done. Well, at least I'm not rushing. I'm practicing like some people, showing total fear in the face of the enemy.
Saw Jack practicing this morning when I arrived.
No, you were accusing nonstop. It's like, mate, no prizes for practicing, mate. Big deal. Anyone can practice hard and stand at the front of a crowd. The real test is to be terrible and bring it on the night. That's where the glory is.
Chris Martin said that.
not standing up and going, yeah, I know, I'm trained.
Yeah, exactly.
You think LeBron James is training every week, mate? No, he's out. He's mucking around. He's just getting into all sorts of mischief.
Yep.
And then you make the finals. Then you have to play well.
Yeah.
Then if you bring it, you're a true hero.
Yeah.
So I'm LeBroning it at the moment. Here's the thing we don't have, and it does fall under the category of buzz.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have an official band photo.
No.
Like for an album or something, if we want to release, or a single, if we want to release a single at the concert or a cast single, I'd like to book that in for this Friday.
That's good.
A band photo.
Yes.
And here's the thing though. What are we wearing? I mean, I know I've had a lot of chat from Jack about how he's going to get a new outfit. I've had an idea.
Glad you brought this up.
I've had an idea.
I'm glad you brought this up because I had a similar feeling. My brother's band, played with a band called Botox, and the lead singer wore
a
pharmacist jacket, like the whole thing.
That's cool.
Look, the band was terrible, Botox, but
they had a move.
They had a look, I thought when I was seeing them, I was like, gee, I mean, I like this band because of their name, Botox. And
they have a kind of a theme.
And his doctor's jacket. Maybe we can get away.
I'm actually going the other way here.
Okay,
I reckon our theme. I mean, maybe we'll come up with a theme accidentally.
Yep.
But I've thought of a rule.
Hmm.
I guess it started on the weekend where I was shopping online for stuff I could want to wear on stage, and I found something.
Okay.
And I went, this will look good. This will look good for the drummer.
Yeah.
But then I thought, wouldn't it encapsulate the spirit of team play that we have in the band
if we all wear it?
If we all follow this rule, you're allowed to buy one thing for yourself.
Yep.
One thing for the other guy, each of the other guys. We all do that.
Okay. So,
and you must wear the thing that the other guys buy you. Yeah. So
should we, like, what if I buy a hat for you and Jack buys a hat for you? How are you going to do that? Wear two hats?
Yep.
No.
Yeah, but you can wear other clothes. That's not all you're wearing.
I know, but I'm saying that with the other item you're buying.
Stop trying to put rules on it, man. It's just fashion. This is the thing. All right, I'll give you a clue.
All about rules.
I'll give you a clue. The thing I found was a hat/helmet that I quite liked.
Okay.
But I've got a couple of ideas floating around for you two, Goose.
Yeah.
Bags. Peace. Couple of goose heads over here.
Yeah.
Not a bad idea. Maybe I'll give you a good big goose outfit.
Okay. So,
Think about what you want for yourself that really encapsulates your stage presence.
So we're not wearing our year 12 formal outfits first gig?
For our first gig. Why don't we wear those to the gig? And then we get changed into. We've got to have costumes. Got to have stage costumes.
Yeah. Well, my dad made out. Remember how I wore all black, with coloured ties?
Yeah.
Yeah. My dad made the ties, and I was thinking of asking him to make three ties for us.
Well, I'm not wearing what you wore to your formal. I'm wearing what I wore, the decorative button.
I thought maybe you wouldn't want to wear the decorative button.
I thought maybe you wouldn't want to wear a stupid fluoro tie. No offense, Mick. You're a good sewer. Here's the thing. We can wear our formal outfits.
Yep.
That's our first gig. We've got a year 10 formal. That's fine. I'm fine for us to do that. But we've got to have stage outfits.
Okay,
we can wear them to the gig.
Oh, mate.
This is what a normal band does. You have a traveling outfit. You have a stage outfit. You have a press outfit. Of course.
You're the one that wanted us wearing the formal outfit.
I've changed my bloody mind.
No surprises.
No, think about what your one item is.
Yeah.
And think about what the other items you're going to make the other guys wear. And yours just got downgraded a lot, mate.
Hey, Cool Boys and the Frontman is our band.
Mm-hmm.
Apologies for going over old ground, but for new listeners, welcome by all means. But we have a band, Haim on electronic drums, Jack on electric guitar, myself, traditionally on trumpet. Our first frontman, and we always have a rotating frontman. We only ever play one song per gig. Our first frontman was Rob Thomas.
Yeah,
Those were days.
We were good, man.
I suppose this is what happens when... and you can drop that now, Jack, but I didn't know you were enjoying it. But I suppose this is what happens when bands that had a huge hit like we did with Thomas back
in the day. That was our first
day.
Single, wasn't it? Yeah, that's when we were single. Feeling the magic and we were up-and-comers. Then we reformed, played at Logie's Pit Roast Party earlier this year with Conrad Zill. That was great. The band, it bubbled along.
Yep. But we've been sitting around like other bands, you know, like Guns N' Roses probably have, but then we're going, gee, we're good back then, weren't we?
And if we had a manager or a record label, they would have probably been going, guys, appreciate your artists, and it takes time to feel it, but you need to kind of get back out there if you want to say you're a band still. Hence the tour was booked. I can't wait, Ando. Mm. And look, because we're going to be doing shows, this radio show is still obviously from every day along the way of the tour. It's the people's tour. Yep. I mean, they're coming along with us, experiencing the thrill, the highs and lows of touring in a very, very deluxe tour coach.
Yes.
It's got a bar on it. It's got amazing, you know, Air Force One chairs. Mm. It's Air Force One in bus form. Mm. You're our bus driver. It's great. Everything's progressing well. I worry that because I've been so focused on the drum and trying to keep you guys in line musically, I worry they've let the team down a bit with Buzz.
Yes.
And one of the key things is getting a band photo, whether it's for a poster or the front of our album or whatever it is. We don't have a band photo. I suggested about an hour ago, let's get a photo this Friday and let's be wearing our stage outfits. And a rule I'm going to implement in the band is we each get to pick one item for ourselves that we can add to our stage personas, then one item for each of the other guys. So I'll be wearing an item that you give me, Jack. I'll be wearing an item that you give me, Ando. And I'll have my item that I'm very interested in buying, and I think I will buy it tonight online.
I just want to...
Mine's a hat, by the way. Mine's headwear.
Just want to say...
It's a Viking helmet.
Okay.
It's a really good quality Viking.
A Viking helmet.
I just think it's a cool
one. Do you want us to be themed?
Nope.
Well, that's a problem.
I want us to be flary. Just buy the thing that you think the other guy needs.
So the village people, that's kind of what you want us to be.
No, because then I'd be saying to you guys, buy me Viking-themed stuff, but I could be wearing a policeman's jacket with a Viking helmet.
But there's no, you don't want us to be linked in any way. I think
wouldn't have to be.
Be nice, though, wouldn't it?
But what our message is, we're an excitement machine. So you've
13 10 60. Are you in a band out there, or were you in a band? 13 10 60. Did you have a band outfit?
Yep.
Who picked it? Did it help the band? Did you discuss band outfits? Did it cause a fracture?
Like, I think if we're all just dressed as Vikings or, you know, warlike people, then what's the point?
So what do you mean? What's the point?
Like, well, I mean, like.
Oh, there's that Viking band.
And we're stuck with Viking stuff.
Yeah, but, I know, but like...
And I'm not sold on the Viking thing, too. If I find a better helmet, I'll go with that. But I just think it's pointless if I'm... Like, if you've got a shield and bagpipes and stuff, it's like, we're just going to get booked to play medieval festivals and stuff. I want it to be...
13, 10, 60.
Like, people look at Kiss and they don't go, oh, they're bikies. They go, no, but they're just exciting.
Yeah, but would you say that Kiss have a theme throughout?
Over time, it's morphed into a theme. But I'd like us to be a Kiss at the beginning. You've played in your brother's band a few times. Is there a discussion before you go on stage about, guys, like, let's just do jeans and a t-shirt, or is it just casual clothes? Like, if you turned up in a bear suit, would they go, mate, no?
Yeah. Yeah, they would.
All right. Well, more accurately, if they're all wearing bear suits and you went, oh, I don't want to do the bear suit tonight, I'm going to be, I'll be a lizard.
Yes. They would probably, if we were all in bear suits, it seems like we're the kind of guys that wouldn't mind a lizard being up there, but... I would definitely have to run it past the band. That's why I don't, you know, I'm not.
Well, you wear bare feet sometimes on stage. I've seen that. What's going on there?
I just find it uncomfortable.
Like, are you allowed to do that, or you have to ask the band if you can take your shoes off at a gig?
No, barefoot's fine. I mean, it's not good.
Just interested to know how much we have to run past each other about our outfits. My idea for the band, if people have just tuned in, is we each have one item of, we obviously wear anything we want, but you have to buy one item of flair for yourself. I'm thinking a Viking helmet for me. And you can buy one item of flair for the other guys, you know, and they have to wear it. Like, if I buy you a cape, you have to wear a cape.
I don't love Viking helmet for you. That's the
you know, it doesn't matter. Change it with yours.
It does matter. And because, you know, we're all part of a team here. The reason being is because Viking helmets traditionally aren't snug fitting.
That's why I'm buying a really good one. I'll get a custom made one.
You can have one if you get a chin strap.
TBC, Jordan on 13, 10, 60.
Get a custom chin strap.
Not bad. I don't mind.
Only because if you're rocking...
I get it, mate.
Okay.
It won't fall off and hit the drums, all right? And I just think it's good to have a Viking on drums. Jordan, ahoy.
Hi, how you going?
Sorry, Jordan. Really good, mate.
Just having a quick fight.
That's all right. That's what we do best in the band. Jordan, you were in a band, mate?
Yes, I was.
Can we ask what the name was?
To the Gallows.
To the Gallows.
It never disappoints. Never band disappoint. Names will never let you down.
How long was To the Gallows rocking, bud?
Around about maybe 3 years. We only broke up about a year ago.
Sweet. That's awesome, that's some solid time rocking.
What did To the Gallows wear? Ye olde English clothes? Do you dress as knights?
No, we played at a nightclub. So we saw it with, you know, those horse masks?
Oh, yeah.
The hard horse masks that go over your whole head.
Yeah.
We all wore them. And we also got some extra ones for the crowd. Chucked them out there and there was people chucking a mosh.
That's pretty good.
Hey, horse,
Jordan,
horse head.
How hard was it? How did the lead singer, he sounded a bit muffled, wouldn't he?
Yeah. Well, I'm the lead singer, so yeah, it did. It sounded pretty crap. And it was really, really loud. really hot up on stage. So
massively. And you can't see anything. You have to look out through the horse's mouth in those. I've got a few.
Yeah, he couldn't see.
So it stopped you from being in the band.
How many times did you do the horse heads?
Just for the one night.
Yeah.
Good on you, Jordan.
Harvey.
Hi, boys. Ahoy.
Ahoy. You're in a band?
Yes, I was for about 3 years.
What was the name?
Nosferatu's Rest.
What?
Nosferatu's Rest.
Like the vampire, yeah.
All right.
I think Nosferatu's the fancier name for vampire.
Okay.
And Harvey, were you guys vampire themed?
We were pretty vampire themed. We looked somewhat like Kiss and had the full makeup and crazy black clothes. And for a few gigs, we used to spit blood out or fake blood out onto the crowd.
Oh, wow.
That would have been a bit spooky for him.
Yeah. So Harvey, kind of like Kiss, but a lot lamer because you've got zero production.
Just incredibly lame. It lasted about 6 months before we got told by one of the local guys who ran the shows, ditch the look, guys, and you'll get some gigs because you don't sound too bad.
Okay.
I don't think we'll have the same feedback coming our way, Harvey, but a good cautionary tale.
Your outfits is what's stopping you.
You guys are actually good musicians. Try to stop spitting blood on people, though. I know this is going to sound weird, but it is putting some people off. Chantel.
Tell us, Chantel.
Ahoy, boy.
Ahoy, Chantel. What was your band name?
The band name was Cactus Gravel.
Good.
Yeah, good.
Excellent.
And what were you, is it a rock band? Was it DJs? What was it?
Yeah, we were a covers band for about 20 odd years.
Okay, wow.
Awesome. And what was your dressing rules?
We started out with different coloured dinner jackets because we had two girls in the band and the rest were guys. We floated between a 6 and a 7 piece with a brass section and all this sort of stuff. So. Yep. We had different coloured dinner jackets, and then my mother-in-law was a seamstress, so we then worked into fancy dress and all sorts of stuff. So,
yeah. Right. So you can have everyone wearing sort of different stuff on stage, and it's good fun.
Well, it's different absolutely. Stuff. They're all wearing dinner jackets.
No, but then they worked into other stuff. They ditched them. They thought they'd look like the formal Wiggles.
Did you? Chantel.
I'm reading between the lines, but that would have come up at band meetings.
Chantel, was it all kind of, though, themed together? That there was a general theme for your whole band?
Nah. Oh, yes and no. Like, the guitarist would have a collection of hats, and the drummer wore different vests.
Over the shop.
Yeah.
It was like Comic-Con. That's the fun of it, Chantel.
Still,
just lots of
still
different
wearing
funny...
the formal jackets.
Nah,
yeah.
All good. Thanks, Chantel. I want it to look like we're in the bloody cantina at Star Wars. You know,
right.
All sorts of spookiness going on.
Mick, you're a drummer in a punk band.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Mick. Can we have the name of the band?
Postscript. We're still playing now. The lead singer just had twins, so we're not playing as many gigs as what we'd like to.
That'll set you back a little
gonna
bit.
It's going to throw a
bit of a spanner in the works.
Yeah. Small spanner in the gigging works.
Super punk of him to go and have a family.
Yeah. That's all right. Punk's got to breathe, otherwise they die out.
What do Postscript wear?
So it's normally the old black jeans, black shirt, you know, the old punk.
Cool.
The punk get up, but there was one night we were playing a gig at the Corner Hotel and I thought I may as well just try something different and try the white singlet. And Haim, you know how hard it is drumming.
Yeah,
about three or four songs in, I was sweating profusely and I was had a white translucent singlet, I think.
See-through.
See-through.
Turned into a wet t-shirt competition and Mick. Your man boobs were just right, jumping around. And we know we've had a man boob problem in this band.
I have had a jiggling issue before with drumming. Was it a nice tight t-shirt, Mick, a nice tight singlet, Mick, that gave you support, or was there sort of visible nipple and jiggle?
No jiggle, just visible nipple. You could see the areoli through the white singlet.
What do you got? Have you got big flat ones? Small dark ones. What are we talking?
I don't think it matters, Mick.
Small good ones.
good ones. See, I'm trying to paint a picture.
I'm just not. Let's see what we come up with.
Mate,
but
where this is what the rule is: come on Friday to the photo shoot. Wear your base layer.
No, we're gonna
wear your base layer, and then you must wear what the other guys give you.
We're going to.
Just lose the vanity, mate.
We're going to reveal the outfits the photo shoot. If we have any problems, we're going to fix them before the photo shoot.
The only rule is you can't pick an outfit that will impede someone's playing. Like, as much as I'd love to give you a muzzle so you can't touch the bagpipe.
I'd love to give you a straitjacket.
I'd still find a way, probably.
Got to talk band. We are part of a band called Cool Boys and the Frontman, everybody, where we are about to go on a tour 2.5 weeks away. Where we're getting in a bus, we're going to go and play different functions along the way, and we plan to have a different front person at every single gig. We only play one song a gig.
Only play one song, AC/DC's Long Way to the Top. We are snaking our way, very metaphorically, halfway to the top, from Melbourne through country Victoria, country New South Wales, all the way to Byron Bay for our final gig of the year. Now, we are Cool Boys in the front, man. Yeah. I'm a cool boy. You a cool boy?
I'm a cool boy.
Jack, you're a cool boy.
I'm getting
cool
there.
Boy. Yeah. Jack, you're making steps every day. And by the time the tour starts, we have three cool boys. Yeah. We have no front men or women yet.
Yes.
And that's why we were having a little chat today.
It's amazing. We thought we'd put our heads down about the getting the front person.
We got to
said.
This is a fun song to sing. Who wants to be our front person?
Not sure if you heard yesterday, but we had the Veronicas on. They got a new single out. It's On Your Side. And we were talking to them about bands and band riffs. This is what came up.
I just have one of those faces that's a real foreground face.
like Jess, who actually believes she is the lead singer of the Veronicas. Yeah. I am the lead singer. I am. I sing more choruses by ratio of song, but I've sung more lead vocals on song. Yes. Well, that's up for negotiation by our therapist. I don't think it is. That's actual reality.
Just tuned in. You're listening to Band Riffs Live on the Hamish and Andy Show.
You're exactly like our band. We thought, gosh, if these guys are this good at fighting, they absolutely need to be a part of Cool Boys in the Front.
They should join the tour.
We thought we were the best at that.
They're amazing at it.
So we reached out to their team. They have said yes, and they join us on the show now. The Veronicas, welcome back.
Cool Boys.
Yes, our first front ladies.
Now, we are so thrilled that you guys are going to be able to do this. You're aware that you guys are playing the first show. We've locked that in, which means you've got to get to Wodonga, Albury Wodonga, on the border of New South Wales and Victoria.
We'll be there, babe. We thought you'd never ask.
Okay.
So sorry we didn't yesterday, but this makes perfect sense. Now, it's a year 10 formal, the first gig. We'll be wearing what we wear. Yeah. We haven't discovered. We don't know our outfits as of yet. But I mean, you guys will be front womaning for us.
Yes.
you can wear your normal gig gear. You can step it up.
We should ask about the song as well.
I mean, you could wear what you want.
We should definitely all creatively collaborate on the vibe for sure.
Collaboration has not been a strong point for this band. All right. Well, the song is Long Way to the Top. How do you guys think you'd go with that one?
We've been singing that since basically the womb, babe.
Really?
You've done it before?
We have done it before. We used to do it on our tours. So we're really versed on this song.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow. Okay, yes. Fantastic. Yep. That's fantastic. And what's the division of labour?
Yeah, do you one person do one bit?
Or are you just going all full throttle from the top, the both of you?
Look, I feel like it's going to have to be a new sort of vibe for this band because we've never played with musicians of your caliber before.
That's
so we're going to have to rework it a little bit, but no doubt there'll be a couple of fights about who sings what.
Do you want to sing more or less?
Yeah, exactly when you got our back.
Where's the fights?
I also loved your not lying there, which is you've never played with a band of our caliber.
I have
the
never
caliber
played.
Is very, very poor.
Never played with a bagpiper as talented as Andy, that's for sure. of that level.
The Veronicas, this is great news. We'll chat more in the next few weeks. We look forward to seeing you on November 28th at the Wodonga Year 10 formal.
And I suppose if you're listening right now from Wodonga Catholic College, that's the band, that's the school we're playing at.
Yeah.
They'll be hearing this for the first time.
Yes.
Like they'll be hearing the Veronicas are coming to our school to play the fall. So bloody big day for them. And who was the name of the PA teacher that's organising?
Mr. West.
Mr. West.
Yeah.
Huge day for Mr. West too in his fledgling career as formal organiser. He's locked in the Veronicas.
Thanks so much, guys.
Can't wait.
Cheers, guys.
Thanks, guys.
Tam, our band, Cool Boys in the Frontman.
A couple of weeks away from the tour, boys. You ready?
I've got to try and get out and do a bit of bus work, I think.
Yeah, we should also practice the song.
We should practice as a group. I should practice some bagpipes before that, and then I should get out and just try and work this bus around.
What's the vibe on the practice? I mean, do you want to do one tomorrow? Does it seem like it's so silly to jam one in on a Friday? Like, is this week just a write-off?
Let's write off this week.
This week feels like a write-off because what's the point of getting all worked up for a Friday? And
we
then
haven't done the song to the end yet.
But also, there's the phenomenon of peaking too soon.
There is. So, yeah. So, are we tapering?
We will also need to taper. So, at some point, where do we want to peak? Probably need to peak
this
next
week.
This
is our band. Hamish is on electronic drums. I'm on trumpet. Actually, that's change of the bagpipes. Jack is on guitar. Yep. Our first ever frontman, because we have a different rotating, very famous frontman. Mm. It was Rob Thomas.
That was good. Actually, you think it was some of our best playing.
Yes. So, at this stage, our song's not at this level, but it will get there. Yeah. We're going to play. We're just playing all your functions, Australia. If you had a function, you registered at hamishandy.com. We start with a Year 10 formal.
Yep.
And we announced about an hour ago that the Veronicas are going to be
front people. They'll be a front people for the show. Then, night after that, we go to a pub reopening in the small town of Rankin Springs. 1,000 people. Yeah. And then we're playing on the back of a semi-trailer, boys. Do you know that? We're playing outside on the back of a semi.
Are we really?
Yeah. It's huge.
Did you know that, Jack?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't know that.
Yeah, mate, it's awesome. Huge. Yeah. It's the thing is, we're a very adaptable band.
Yeah.
I mean, we're a rock and roll band because we're playing AC/DC's Long Way to the Top.
How rock and roll and country is off the back of a semi-trailer?
It's awesome.
In fact, I think the film clip for Long Way to the Top, the song we're playing,
a semi-trailer just driving up there.
Not quite a semi; it's just I think it's a small truck.
Flatbed. It's a budget truck they got for the weekend. And then they were moving. Angus Young was moving, and they used that on the Sunday after they finished filming.
Hey, you are in charge of Buzz. We've got our Cool Boys in the Frontman Instagram
going well.
You said though, and I agree with you that we should have outfits of some description.
Well, because I think the assumption was we were just going to play in casual clothes.
And certainly works for Angus Young in AC/DC.
He's a schoolboy.
Empire of the Sun is another Australian band that did very well.
We'll be here all day if we name the literally dozens of bands that have dressed in different clothes on stage. Yeah. We hadn't had a talk about it, and I thought it would be a nice team building exercise.
Yep.
If, and as a bit of fun, we all get to pick one item for ourselves, a special item, but we can also make, we have a card to play. We can make each other person in the band wear one item each. So I can make you wear something and I can make Jack wear something. Then you can make me wear something. You can make Jack wear something, et cetera. Do you want to go first? Have you guys got yours?
Oh, yeah.
We don't all have them all physically here, do we?
No, I've got none of mine here.
And we were going to do a photo shoot tomorrow. We push that back to sometime next week because, again, is it silly to get all fired up for a Friday and then you just cool down over the weekend?
Exactly.
So, but what we've done is we've written them down to avoid any double ups or miscommunication here.
Or just anyone changing it late.
Yeah. Okay. I don't want any changed out of revenge in the moment.
Yeah. Okay, so do you want me to go first or do you want...
Oh, do you want to go first? Yeah, go first.
Okay.
What have you picked for yourself? Kilt. Yeah, thought you would.
I thought just keep with the Bad Vibes theme.
Yep.
It would feels like I'm honouring the Scottish by doing that. Yep. I'll dishonor them with the sounds I'll make out of the bag, so I might try and win it back.
Yep.
For Haim, obviously for AC/DC, it really worked for Angus Young in the schoolboy outfit.
Nice.
And I thought, cool, you know, older guy dressing younger. Maybe it's cooler to go even younger. So I thought an adult pacifier.
A dummy.
So just a rock god with a dummy in his mouth.
Do they make adult pacifiers?
Yeah, they do. I looked it up.
It'd be massive.
It's massive.
Interesting.
So,
So, you know, that's obviously...
I don't love it.
You idiot, try and make himself look cool.
That's all right. Because kilts are the coolest of all time.
I think you secretly want to wear the kilt.
Yeah, I do. I'm up for that, for the bagpipes.
So and I just have to be a giant baby. That's...
No, that was...
I'm the baby.
That's for
Hamish.
That's
for you. Because
obviously, I can't put in shoes or anything of anything.
You don't really
see him. So no. I've just gone for something that's going to be head-based so people can see it. And I knew you had covered off hat.
It's good.
Oh, thank God.
Okay. And so for Jack...
I actually think it'll really work because it'll give me something to chomp on as I'm just grinding out the drums.
Yeah.
Do I get the chain so I can drop it out of my mouth if I need to talk?
Absolutely.
Or the clip that babies have for their... Yeah, great. Can I bedazzle it once I get it? Like, can I put a skull and crossbones on it?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. It's just yours. And then, Haim, what do you think about this for Jack?
That's so funny. That's what I was going to make you wear. That's awesome.
Okay, I haven't seen it yet.
Roller skates?
That does inhibit my playing. Because I can't roller skate properly.
You're just standing
so I'll fall
in
everywhere.
No, you're just standing in one spot.
Just put your stoppers down and go for it.
Oh, I don't know. All right, I'll try, but I think it feels dangerous. Like, I'll just go off the side of the semi-trailer.
You're meant to be dangerous. Live on the edge
of
the
rock god. You're a rock god.
I was going to do a jump, like a guitar jump. Not anymore.
Well, I think people would love to see you in roller skates.
Okay.
Oh, gee.
So we play in these outfits here as well?
You have to. Yeah. This is your stage outfit.
Not just a photo shoot outfit.
No, mate. You wear this. This is like Madonna. She didn't just do the cone bra off stage. Mm. She wore it out there. She did it all. Just realizing I should have made you wear a cone bra. That would have been great. Oh, well, too late. Can't change now. I've written it down. The rule is we can pick one cool thing for ourselves and one cool thing for everyone else to wear. And you've made your selection. You're wearing a kilt.
Yes.
You've picked for yourself. I have to wear an adult. I have to chew on an adult dummy.
Yep.
Just to give me a cooler edge. And Jack, you're in roller skates.
Yes.
Not blades.
Not blades.
So we'll have to find some adult skates for you. Jacko, what have you picked for yourself? Bet it's a leather jacket or something.
Yeah. Let me go. I'll give you your guys first and then I'll finish on mine. So for Andy, I thought I would do something to match the mustache that you're growing for the tour. It's a monocle.
Oh, wow. Okay.
That's good.
So
yeah, I suppose. I might have
to tape it on.
Yeah, it'd be hard.
It's tough to wear a monocle, isn't it? Because you've got to squeeze it in your eye.
Yeah, but
you'll look cool.
We'll find a way. Find a way to get it on.
Yeah, cool. Can I have it?
You'll look like a British detective.
Can it be a transition lens?
Sure.
Okay, just
I think it needs to be a perfect monocle. Oh, you want to do go sunglasses?
Just sunglasses.
When you're outside.
Playing on the back of a semi. Yeah, Jack. Yep.
Haim, for you, because you drum a lot with your shirt off, I actually think you like this one.
Sports bra, hopefully.
Spray tan.
Yes. So do I have to get that next week for the photo?
You have to get it for the photo shoot and then...
Then it wears off, then I get another one for the thing.
I think so,
Redo, how often is he redoing it?
He'll do one before the photo shoot and then one just at the start of the tour.
Yeah, good idea.
Should see you through to the end.
A tanned baby with a bikey.
And then what are you
going to do? Okay, so then I'll pass you what I thought I'd get for myself. I didn't know what the budget was or if it was a band expense or...
This is unbelievable.
He wants a
Gibson SG tribute electric guitar.
That's the one that Angus Young plays in the video clip.
You want a new guitar. These are not band expenses, by the way.
This is what I'd like to wear for myself.
Sorry, I didn't know. Is this a band expense? Because otherwise,
no, this is not a band expense.
Anyway. Well, then I'll go back to the drawing board.
We're not buying you a $2,000 guitar, mate.
Okay, I didn't know.
Okay. Yeah, no, it needs to be clothing, pal. Just look organized. Instruments don't count as clothing. Yeah. All right, back to the drawing board for that one.
Okay. I'd like to wear $40,000 in cash. Is this a band expense?
Guys, you're not going to believe it. Mine's a $100,000 diamond. Can I show you my helmet first?
Yeah, looking forward to this helmet.
Guys, not just a Viking helmet.
Oh, it's great.
Thank you. More of a Shogun metal helmet with horns.
Yeah, exactly. Because
I hope it is a band expense. This is not cheap.
That looks heavy.
Super
so
heavy.
So to describe everyone, it is a complete,
fully metal helmet.
A full metal helmet with horns attached to the top. That's great. Can you whack it on for us?
Won't fit with the headphones and stuff. Yeah, it's really good. And also, it's a little bit painful to wear. I'm going to have to get a blacksmith to rework it a bit.
Okay. Certainly not a band expense. It worries me, Ham, that you can't headbang. That seems limited.
No, it's got a strap.
It's got a strap. Seemed a little limiting.
I'll sort it out, mate. Okay. Doesn't matter. It looks tough as hell. Ando.
Yeah.
What do we do with you, Mr. Lee? So I thought I wanted to get you to wear something that encapsulates the journey we've come on. Mm-hmm. And because Jack and I play real instruments, guitar and drums, the heart and soul of this song, and you've transitioned from the trumpet to the bagpipes, both novelty instruments, often referred to as the sombrero of instruments, you know, funny to have, but not necessary.
Perfectly great for sun protection.
You, my friend, will be wearing a sombrero with the Quit logo on the top because you are not allowed to smoke. You're banned from smoking cigarettes.
You're playing. What do we do about that?
It's got a rope underneath. It's a soft sombrero.
No. But I'm like my pipes go. Easy.
I'll cut a pipe hole in it if you want.
I'll cut a pipe hole
in the brim. But you're still wearing the sombrero.
Okay, great.
With the Quit logo on top.
Yep.
Now this.
Happy with that.
This, for Jack, this is the thing that's made me giggle.
All day,
because I just keep looking over at him, imagining him with his guitar, electric guitar, and wearing his leather jacket.
Hamish has passed it over, but I can't see yet what it is.
Don't you reckon it?
I'm nervous.
A sequined eye patch.
A sequined eye patch?
Yeah. You're going to wear an eye patch like a pirate.
I mean, because you've been giggling at me all day, I expected a lot worse.
I know. I don't know why. I just think it's so you're going to have to wear an eye patch and roller skates on.
That seems dangerous.
An eye patch and roller skates would be funny.
You're going to be the coolest boy in the world.
Awesome. All right, great. Well, we can get all these together by next week for the photo
shoot. So, Ando, you're in a monocle and a sombrero and a kilt.
Yeah.
I'm in this sort of medieval big steel Viking helmet.
A pacifier.
An adult dummy spray tan. Mm. Jack, you haven't picked an item for yourself, but our items for you are, roller skates and an eye patch. That's a band, guys.
Yeah, it's good stuff.
That's a band.
Yeah. Awesome.
Should rehearse that.
Guy, we have our own band. It's called Cool Boys and the Frontmen.
I'm very well aware, mate.
You're aware of it?
We know you're aware of it, Guy. Yeah. Now, our tour, you tour a bit, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yep. We're doing one. our tour kicks off November 28th. Yeah. Kicks off in Melbourne. We've got a tour bus, a really fancy one. And he's the bus driver.
Yep.
Hence, he's got his moustache growing nicely. Yes. We'll dye it silver before we take off because
that'll save you some money. I'll pay mine way too much.
Yeah. We're driving, snaking our way up, finishing in Byron Bay. 2nd of December.
Yes.
Our last show of
the year. The Beach Hotel. Have you ever played the Beach Hotel, Guy?
I haven't personally.
Yeah, it's a very highly regarded venue. Yeah. So today we wanted to announce who is going to be the front person of Cool Boys and the Frontman for that special gig, the final show of the year, huge. December 2nd, the Friday. Wow.
Now, Guy, we know you know about this gig, but I suppose we can do this with you here. Have to. We've been putting this off for too long.
And a lot of people have come forward and asked for the gig.
Tons of people.
Obviously, and
today on the show, we thought we're going to make our decision from our shortlist. So bear with us while we just play this out.
What's up? This is Beyonce.
Hi, it's Katy Perry.
Hey, I'm Ed Sheeran.
What's up, guys? It's Justin Bieber.
This is Taylor Swift.
And I'm Guy Sebastian. We've all asked to perform with Cool Boys and the Frontman. It would be a dream come true for any one of us, and now we eagerly await the decision.
Right, so there you go. All those artists have asked us to be the
front.
That's
impressive, that lineup.
You're in exclusive company, Guy. Hope you don't mind us discussing this in front of you.
It's a bit rude, but...
Well, look, you heard with Beyonce there. I mean,
Bieber throws tantrums.
Bieber's out for me. He's out for me. He's out.
Yells at his fans. We don't do that. We yell at each other, but we don't yell at our fans.
Ed's got red hair.
Ed's on holiday, isn't he?
Ed's on holiday. And is he still on his digital holiday?
Well, he's coming out of it to want to play with us, but I reckon he'd be rusty.
He'd be rusty. So he hasn't practiced in a year.
Yeah.
We know Katy Perry is really rattled about the Trump thing. Yes. I just don't think we'd be getting her in the best mood.
Yep.
You've got Beyonce then. Look, on the surface, a good pick. We know Guy's has met her, but his wife has cried around her.
Yep.
And it would be an easy way for me to become best friends with her, but it would be cheating. And I don't want to abuse my power from playing in a powerful band to just become friends with Beyonce, so she would be out for me.
Who does that leave us with?
Good Guy Sebastian.
Guy Sebastian, let's go!
Yes!
Wow. The year of the underdog continues.
Giddy up.
Guys, sorry to have to do that in front of you. That was
my
probably
God,
poor form.
I had a lump in my throat because for a second it looked like we weren't going to go with you.
I thought you were going to go to an ad break then and keep me in more suspense.
We were just going to go, you know what? No one on the list makes We'll keep taking submissions. Guy, you have won out. Your beard really impressed us, more so than all the other artists that begged to play as the frontman of Cool Boys and the Frontman.
Guys, you know what you're in for?
I know that how you boys roll, so lots of parties. I know that bus is going to be a den of complete iniquity.
Well, it's Byron.
I was going to talk about the music.
Yeah. Can you sing Long Way to the Top by AC/DC? I mean, you can sing anything.
I just know the Akadaka fans, would they go, oh, Guy Sebastian, what's he going to do with
they
that?
Will. They'll love
I
it.
Guess that's the jeopardy, isn't it? People are going to be tuning in.
Hey, we're all scared.
That is why people love Cool Boys and the Frontman.
Hey, we're all scared. Right. We actually are petrified every time we play, so it's nice to have a frontman who's joining
us. We just argue instead of learning the song.
But, Guy, thank you. We look forward to seeing you at the Byron Bay Beach Hotel December 2nd. Also, everybody.
How's this? This is exciting.
Tickets are on sale. You can buy tickets to this gig. They're going to be on sale Monday morning at 9 a.m. at oztix.com.
So you obviously have to, if you're going to be in Byron or you can get to Byron on Friday the 2nd, you can be part of that limited and special crowd.
Monday morning, 9 a.m, oztix.com. Thanks so much, Guy. We look forward to seeing you soon.
Thank you.
Yes. See you at soundcheck, man.
Good idea, guys.
See you at soundcheck. Good afternoon, everyone. Hamish out in the drive, you're home. Couple of big announcements on today's show. First of all, the sliding championships. We talked about this on Friday.
This has gone airborne.
Yes. Talked about that the Olympics.
Yep.
Or, in fact, there's no sport out there that represents sliding.
You're right. Well, here's what we said exactly. You got running and jumping and throwing.
Hopping is in...
Hopping the form of jumping.
In triple jump.
It's in there. But you don't have...
Sliding.
You don't have sliding.
Yeah.
So then a bunch of people go, hey, what about the Winter Olympics? That's all sliding.
Like, yeah.
That's... gliding.
Yeah.
It's swooshing. Quite a lot of swooshing at the Winter Olympics.
Yeah. So, all right. Or skating.
And skating. So we rephrase.
Yeah.
This, what we're going to run at the end of this week will be Australia's only indoor room temperature sliding championships. Okay? That's a skill that's underrated. We're talking about sliding in your socks on the kitchen floor.
Yes.
Not sliding in the luge pipe. You rich jerks. Come on. We're Jamaica in this story, if anything.
We've got a
huge
announcement with regards to the prizes now that are up for grabs with regards to our sliding championships. But bigger news than that was today, our tour tickets went on sale, Ham. Our final show for our band, Cool Boys and the Frontman, will be, of course, at the Byron Bay Beach Hotel.
Yep.
Guy Sebastian was confirmed as the frontman for that gig.
Here's some exciting news, Ando.
Well, tickets went on sale at 9 a.m. this morning. You said you got the info.
For that gig, 1,000 tickets went on sale because, again, this looks suspicious, but we promised this was more of an accident, more of, you know, hey, we'll go where the tour and the bus takes us. Mm. It is schoolies when we're there.
Yeah.
But, you know, we've got caps. Mm. We wear sneakers. we're still with it, man.
Yeah, yeah.
Like the average, the median age between my son and I is 18.
Exactly. So,
between my son and I, like, you know, he and I are just like a couple of average 18-year-olds hanging out when we hang out.
Which means we have to bring Sonny for that.
It's like
idea
having a fake
sense.
ID, but he keeps our group's median age down. So here's the thing: we're at the Byron, at the Beach Hotel in Byron Bay, iconic for people that whether you've been or not, like it's huge. Tickets on sale, as you said, this morning.
We're going to play that gig live on the radio as well, everybody.
That will be 4 to 6. Yep. That gig will be 4 to 6. Yep. Guy Sebastian being our front man as we play Long Way to the Top. Still haven't learned it. Doesn't matter. We will this week.
Saw Jack practicing today.
What a nerd. I knew you would, Jack. Put that on ice for another discussion. Ando, as of, did a quick check 10 minutes ago, ticket levels still the same as they were when I checked about 3 hours before that.
What depends what the level is.
Sold out. And we made the news.
Jack,
we made the news.
Jack, put a bigger cheer in.
No, Jack, play him the bit from the news.
Okay. Well, it's official. Cool Boys and the Frontman are a smash, baby. Selling out in 3 hours. Wowzers. Grab your boogie boards and your best buddies and head to Byron Bay for the gig of the year.
Well, don't, because it's sold out.
Yeah, but it'd be fun to be around. Well, you mate, take it with the news. All I can do is just trawl the airwaves and pull these bits and pieces off as I see them.
Well, that's a relief.
Isn't that great? So last gig's a total sellout in a good way.
That's great.
But here's... So that's the good news.
Yes.
And I did warn you that we had a minor debacle in our midst.
Yeah.
So as I put up an Instagram this morning, a picture of our... We got a flag made. Yeah. Like a cool flag made.
Yeah, it's awesome.
For it's like a banner kind of thing to hang at the gig.
Yeah.
For our Byron Bay gig, last gig of the year. Cool Boys in the Front Man.
With the Cool Boys in the Front Man symbol.
That's right. Do you notice anything a bit weird about that symbol now?
No.
Because it's drumsticks going into a guitar, going into a trumpet.
Yeah.
But we've cancelled trumpet out of it. We don't have trumpet in our band. We've made the wrong logo.
But are we still playing the secret song?
I mean, the secret song... I think for what... The secret song could have trumpet in it, but... For what people know the band plays, we're drums, guitar, and bagpipes because we're playing long way over the top.
What are we thinking then? Do we change the symbol?
Well, one idea I had was we could paint on like a ball or a towel or something that we're shoving in the end of the trumpet so it's been silent.
No, that's not the symbol. That's not what we're... This is not what our
band's put a cross at. Over the trumpet. Because we are anti-trumpet.
No, we're not anti-trumpet. We're very pro-trumpet.
Oh, some of us have been anti-trumpet. Here's the thing, though. 131060, our band now has an inaccurate logo.
Yes.
Look, we're probably going to stick with it because we've got all the... Like, the wheels are in motion.
And the band is that.
It was formed with the spirit of trumpet in mind.
Yes.
Even though we've successfully culled the trumpet from our band. Cut it off.
This is not natural selection.
Like
this is
a
not
dag,
evolution.
Like a dag off a sheep. That was the trumpet.
I don't... really appreciate the trumpet being referred to as a poodle.
And in 1060, though, could we start the show with logo mishap? Have you got the wrong logo for your business? Because we got the wrong one for our band. We're sticking with it.
Yeah.
I'll take logo mishaps that you fixed or that you just live with.
Did your company evolve and the logo stay still? 131060 people are already calling through.
Katie, ahoy.
Hi, how are you going?
Yeah, good, mate. Did you have a logo that, logo mishap?
I do. I used to work for a pizza company a few years back, and we sent off to get a marquee made up, and it came back stating that we sold pizzas, cold drinks, and pork robs.
Good on, Rob.
So I suppose that's
do you
what,
have
that's
any
when...
vegetarian robs? I'm so sorry, pork robs only.
So I suppose that's when you have a meeting and go, "Do we change the logo
or do we invent a
new
food?"
We definitely had to. We actually had a few times. If you mentioned pork robs, you got half price.
Embrace the mistake. That's exactly
who's
what.
Here's your new mascot. Oh, that's Pork Rob. That's our mate Robbie. He's just covered in ham. So we're just seeing if it works. He's got a jacket made of ham singles.
And he wears a pig
hey,
hat.
Hey, Pork Rob.
Thanks, Katie. Melanie, on 131060, a logo mishap?
Yes. Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Mel.
My husband and I started up a very small business. I was on Vistaprint on the internet, and I got a bit carried away with business cards, tote bags. I got him a polo shirt. We only have four clients, but you know, it's very tempting.
Yeah,
so
I love
we
you, Mel.
This...
Mel, you sound like the Hamish of our group.
You're great, Mel.
When it all arrived, I instead of having JMS Business Services, I'd left out the E, so it was Cervix. A business Cervix.
Right.
So,
right.
And we've just gone with it.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. Sure, you have to. I suppose when you've got that much, merchandise on you.
Yeah, well, most of your assets are tied up in merchandise. It'd be terrible for the balance sheet if you had to mulch them.
Renee, your brother's had a logo mishap similar to our band.
Yeah, and the thing that's funny about this is he's actually got this tattooed on him, so it's kind of stuck with him for life.
Mm.
He has the Northern Territory album on his chest with the emu, kangaroo, and then he's got born and bred, true territorian.
Okay, true bread, territorian, yep.
Yeah, true territorian. Bred is spelt wrong. Instead of it being B-R-E-D, it's B-R-E-A-D.
He's going with the food.
Yeah.
And it's tattooed on him, and it's literally not going anywhere.
No, that's tattoos.
Yeah, that's
100% tattoos.
Is he...
I just asked Jack. He's got two little birds diving for food down his crack.
If they could go somewhere,
yeah, they would. They're both trying to flee and hide in that hole.
Those birds would have been told to go
Jack
home to their nest.
Song.
Jack. Oh, Jack thought we needed a hit.